10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to Thursday Night Life Fly Tying, the show where passion for fly fishing meets creativity and camaraderie. It's our sixth season, and we're thrilled to have you with us. Without all of you who purchased season 6 kits and our fantastic sponsors, we wouldn't be able to keep going. So for this, we want to start with a huge thank you, Morning View Mercantile, Lyle Peterman Real Estate, Craft Bear Nation, Rocky Mountain Fly Shop, Shore Fishing, Fishbond, Fly Fusion, and Friesen Brothers. Born in a humble brewery in 2018, our journey began with a simple idea to bring together like-minded souls for an evening of stories, laughter, and the art of fly tying. Our doors were always open, our hearts always welcoming. When the tides of time brought challenges, we evolved. From a cozy corner in a brewery to screens across the world, Thursday Night Life Fly Tying transformed into a virtual stage, forging the unbreakable TNL fam. Every Thursday, join our hosts, the ever-entertaining Dana and the skilled artisan Tim, as they weave magic with their stories and skills. Dana brings the laughter, and Tim brings the craft. Tonight, as always, we tie two unique patterns, celebrate our wins, and share a toast with our favorite beverage from our friends at Craft Beer Nation. Stay tuned for surprises, fly and go and prizes, and above all, the love that binds the TNL fam. Let's dive into the world of fly tying together.
Quite the slow bring in there, yeah, with that music.
It was wrong song.
Oh, man, started already. Not improving.
This is it. Welcome back. The last time, maybe this was it.
What is your playlist over there?
I don't know.
Are you searching in like?
Hang on. Yes, that's why your microphone's muted, because I. Maybe it's this one. There it is,
there
folks.
There it is. That's better.
Welcome back to episode 13, the final of episode 13.
Episode 13.
Season 6.
Season 6.
Episode 13. I'm Dana.
And I'm Tim.
He's Tim.
He's Tim.
And we've been coming to you for the last 3.5 months. 13 plus 1. So 14 before Christmas. And season 6, so over 6 years. 2018 is when this racketeer began. And
good times,
oh, wow,
been rolling.
Has it changed and evolved and grown?
Yes.
But they say if you're not growing, you're dying.
That That's not it, I don't think.
That's why I keep eating.
I don't think that's the saying, but okay.
Something like that. It's very similar. It might be different. If you know the actual phrase, let me know in the comments. Also, let us know what you're drinking, where you're from, because this part of the show, when we start the show, you can see beside me and Tim, it's the $10,000 Lucky Flybox donation giveaway. And, well, Tim tallied it up today, and what's the total?
I got $18,400
in giveaways. $18,400
in giveaways.
And we're not even counting one of the blooper prizes.
Yeah, that's priceless.
That's priceless. Because I mean, really. You can't put a price on things like that.
Nope.
So anyways, we're going to talk more about that. But just know that if you're here, it's not by accident. It is a divine intervention into your life. Fly tying was boring at one time. Not anymore. Your Thursday nights were blah. Not anymore. Well, there will be blah again next Thursday.
Next Thursday.
Because this is it.
It's all over.
Until December. January. Oh, I think somebody commented like 37 weeks until we meet again. And that is
that it? Oh,
about geez. How it's going to go.
I think we had Roger a little scared there. He says he lives in the south, and when he hears banjos, he gets nervous.
Oh, squeal like a pig, boy.
Oh, man. Yeah, you're like really good at that. Yeah. Squeal like a pig.
I've been to the south. I know what they're all about. I know what Roger's all about.
Oh, man.
Hugh McDougall checking
What's
in from
up?
Maine.
From Maine.
Got his tickets. Ron's got his tickets. Troy's got his tickets. Arctic Grayling got his tickets. Roger got his ticket. Mr. Pape got his ticket. Doug got his ticket. Travis, Troy, Cole, Dusty, Barry, Dan, everyone in here has got their donations in. Infamous NAC, glad I found you guys. This is my first season. It will not be the last.
Amazing.
Keep up the good vibes always. But at one point, we have to go fishing.
Yeah, and it seems like it's about that time.
This weekend.
Yeah.
So anyways, Tim, why don't you tell everybody a little bit about the flies that we are going to be tying tonight?
Yeah, absolutely.
And then I'm just going to let you know I'm drinking a...
Did I get you the wrong one?
Yeah, it's non-alcoholic again.
Oh. Let's just say the beer cooler is getting a little thin and we're getting down to the near beers. We'll fix that in a second.
Okay.
All right.
You tell them what the flies are. I'm going to go fix this right now. I'm thirsty.
Okay, so tonight, guys, we have a busy night. We have, obviously, this with our giveaway happening. We have a ton of stuff to do later in the show, but we are going to tie. We're going to get through these last two patterns from our season six. So the two you can see there, we've got a couple of really fun ones. We've got a caddis, which is pretty similar to one of the other caddises we did this year called the Peterborough caddis. And then we have the Circus Peanut Hopper, which is, again, a very similar pattern we've done in the past, just a little bit different take on it. So for our Never Sink Caddis, you guys can go ahead. That's where we're going to start tonight, is on that fly. So if you want to get your kits prepared, go ahead, pop those out. We're going to be using some little bit lighter thread on that tonight. So we're going to be using some tan or brown UTC 70, something a little smaller for that dry fly. Get your kit prepared, because when we do hit these flies tonight, we're going to move through them pretty steady as we do have a fairly full show tonight. So
full show, meaning we're going to spend some time going over. What did we figure? There was 32 prizes.
There's 32.
32 packages.
32 prize
I don't think one of them was under
$300. None of them were under
$300.
None. No.
Wow.
Crazy.
Do the math. You can't, because you don't know what they're all worth. So anyways, I went over there and I found something different. It's called a Ghost Pepper Hefeweizen from Rail Yard Brewing via Craft Beer Nation.
Yes.
All right. That's where we get all our craft beers from. And they're located on Gasoline Alley in Red Deer, Alberta, Canada.
Actually, they're located upstairs right now.
Are they here?
They're here.
Who else is here?
Everybody. It's a busy household today.
We had the TNL final episode brisket party, and it's full house.
Full house, just the way we like it.
Just checking the cameras over there, and it's still on the brisket. Nobody wanted to take it and walk around the house. So I'm going to try this. Tim, tell them what you're drinking. We're going to hit the commercial. We're going to come back. We're going to see who's on the couch. And by that, I mean who's starting on the couch,
yes. I've got a farmer's tan. Belgian white. I think you've had this
one before. Well, if you wear a t-shirt on the river, you technically get a farmer's tan.
It's true. I don't have one yet.
That's a good point.
But I'm going to see what this one's all
about. Okay, so he's drinking a farmer's tan. I'm drinking the Ghost Pepper Hefeweizen. Let us know in the comments what you're drinking. And let's give a thank you to our sponsors who make this entire show happen. the giveaways happen.
In the heart of nature, when hunger strikes and time is of the essence, Morning View Mercantile has the solution. Witness how we redefine convenience. It's not just a meal, it's an experience. In mere moments, a feast emerges. Delight in the flavors of the wilderness. Morning View Mercantile, your partner in adventure, your ally in taste. For every adventure, a memorable meal. Morning View Mercantile, where every bite is an expedition.
Being up in the high Rockies, or up in that area, the different species, right? Still looking to get a brookie under the belt, still looking to get a bull under the belt, but you know, the fish are amazing, and just the landscape is second to none.
All right. So how was that beer?
I'm really enjoying this one. It's very, very smooth, I will say. As the beers have gone, this one's up there.
One has a hit.
Well, it's called Ghost Pepper Hefeweizen.
But without further ado, which much further delay, with no greater way to say,
oh,
who came to play on the couch?
Couple of handsome gentlemen right there.
Look at that. Whoa. We got Mr. Ted on the one side, and we got Ken number two on the other side.
Double Kens.
Why don't you guys say hello to the fine folks of Thursday Night Live?
Welcome, viewers.
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for having us along.
Yeah.
And why don't you tell us a little about where you're from, who you are, and what you do? And Ted's drinking a beer, so why don't you tell us about that beer?
I'm drinking... People Skills, very nice lager. Yep, I would buy that again.
Nice.
Good. Well, where are you from?
Originally from British Columbia. Moved here about 6 years ago. So
nice. And now,
and
where's
I do
here?
Nothing. I'm retired.
Oh. Where's here?
Olds.
Oh, Olds, Alberta. Alberta. See, not everyone knows where we're from. Ken, why don't you tell everybody where you're from, what you do?
I was born and raised in Calgary and now live in Linden, Alberta. And I'm an office manager for a heavy-duty equipment company. Nice. But I'd rather be fly fishing.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
We all know that feeling.
And you might just lose some of this. I think I could make a fly.
Oh, don't get on my boat. I bring that on my boat for people.
There is some skunking on your boat.
There's some skunk. No, wait.
Not like that. Have you skunked? Yeah.
Remember that time the river blew up? Me and Troy this year tried.
We skunked. All three of us. Hard. It's bad when you put three guides in a boat.
And then you just mortar out. Yep. And then I melted my mortar.
Ah, you did. That was a bad day all around.
I know. That was a bad day. All right. So that's kind of how it goes. We got people on the couch. We got a whole bunch more people. I'm just checking in on their camera. I'm going to see if I can switch it up over here and check and see what's going on.
Oh, there are
all
some
right,
peeps
so
in
we
there.
Got some folks in the back. They're going to be about a 12-second delay. So Tiffany has no idea that she's chomping away on camera, but she's going to hear it soon. And you're going to see her poke her head up. Right? Wait, see? They're three, super delayed. Two, one. Look, we're here, Adrian says. if you recognize that spot, that is the old studio.
Yeah, a little tighter than
so,
this one.
Hey, look, see now it's like super delayed, but anyways, they're here. We've got a house full. Looks like Ren's wearing Renegade. The birthday hat, and those are the folks in the old days. Hey!
Ken enough.
And, whoa. Oh,
I don't know who
Cloodle-doodle.
That is.
Cloodle-doodle. So they're in the old studio. It's set up now as what we call the green room. They're just chomping at the bit to get in here on the couch.
Yes.
And say hi to everybody, all of you guys. That's
nice.
Kind of how that goes. And then we can pop ourselves back to the couch, which would be this camera. There we go.
Look at you go. You're so organized tonight.
All right. You guys got 5 seconds each to leave. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm out of here.
Five seconds each. You don't get to think about it. What is your favorite fly? 2, 3, 4, 5.
Turk's tarantula.
Turk's tarantula. Turk's tarantula. Good fly.
Ted?
Chironomids.
Yes.
Yeah, you can go.
I told you. Ted is a chironomid man.
PC boy. I get it.
And
it's
he's going to have a very special day getting skunked on a special place.
At the bike racks. Yep.
Anything else you guys got for the folks? Should we check in with the other TNL fam who's up here in the comment section?
Yeah, there's a say big what's group happening. In here tonight.
Yeah. All right. It's hard to believe it's the last episode, and that's a fact. Trout Maharishi, I'll throw in a chest freezer. You'll have to come and get it and take all the contents with you.
Still the old life.
We know what's in his deep freeze. Jerry from Sundry. John Miller from Mission, Texas.
Yeah. Oh, we got your old Janine.
The beautiful Janine. Hi, everyone. Drinking a booster juice in Red Deer.
She lives at the party, and she left the party.
She left the party to go sit in Red Deer. Crazy.
We got Paul.
We
D.
need a TNL support group to make it through this. That's a good point. And we have the spot for you.
Yes.
For $700 a day, you can sit on my drift boat, and I will make sure that
we'll get rid of the blues.
That you can get through the summer. Arctic, you give me an excuse to drink beer and tie flies on a Thursday. Yes. Girlfriend even reminds me.
Oh, nice.
That's good. You've got a keeper. She's like, hey, what are you doing? You're in bed. It's Thursday at 7. And you're like, oh, I got to get up and drink beer and tie flies. Hang out.
Could be better.
The coolest people on the planet. Rick Flink here from Kalispell, Montana. It's great to see you. And it's sad because it's the end of the season. Now it's time to get in the water.
Yeah.
I did get the picture of the sage blank and the components. Yes. And that is in the giveaway.
That is.
Thank you, Mr. Flink. Mining of the North. Rum and a Coke.
Nice.
Scotty Borschelt. Pabst Blue Ribbon in Detroit.
In Detroit.
What about there's a Bell's. Scotty drink Bell's I think it's called Bell's. It's what we had in Kalamazoo. I mean, I was an athlete, I didn't drink, so I just saw the signs every once in a while.
You're an athlete, so you drink more.
Does the second round of purchase tickets at 8:57 still count? So good question here is that you guys can buy tickets. We're going to say stop buying tickets and we're going to do the draw. So we're going to kind of give you like a 5-minute heads up. You can keep going online and buying tickets. And how do you do that? Well, we're going to head over here into this scene and just check out tonight's flies again. In case you didn't get the thread, Tim's going to tell you what the thread is so that you can put the thread in and then you can't complain when Tim switches up on you.
Just throws me under the bus. Never have switched it once. Not even once in you guys.
I went back and checked. I went back and checked.
You did? I don't want to know.
I double checked.
It was your fault, right? Burns. You told them.
This isn't bad, but it burns.
Well, it's the ghost pepper.
Oh, ghost pepper.
ghost pepper.
That's the ghost pepper.
So you got your flies there, guys. You can see the fly below. The thread below. We got UTC 70 in tan or brown or something darker for that first fly. And then we're going to go nice and pink if you have it, or something tan or lighter colored for the second fly. And that's going to be a little heavier as we're working with that foam. Don't want to cut the foam, and we want something that'll bind nicely. So we're going to use something a little heavier there. I suggested that UTC 140. That's what we got for flies.
Just Just checking in the comments here. Derek Stewart says, howdy, Tim. Long time no talk.
Oh, what's up, Derek?
Ignoring him.
Apparently. He's also a custom rod maker.
Tom is drinking Wilderness Rye. Jasper Brewing Company. Chris Pills. That's actually a good beer. Okay, so now that we got our flies and we're going to get to tying those right away, we need to go in, do this and say, oh, giveaways.
Gotta show them how to do it.
Something like this.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've accumulated 32 packages. Some are worth a lot more, mm-hmm. and some are worth not less than $300. Yeah. Right? So we've packaged fly boxes full of flies. We've got swag. We've got t-shirts. We got hat. We got fly rods. We got reels. We got fly line. We got waders. We got boots. We got fly fishing trips. We got overnight stays at fly fishing lodges. We've got a lot of stuff.
Lots of things.
It's just simple. You make a donation to the show, you're entered. And you just got to go up here, click on that link. You can't click on it. It's a live stream. But if you enter it in there, and I'll maybe enter it in the comment section over there.
Yeah, that works.
Probably won't because I don't know how to do that.
Somebody will. They'll do it for
you. Somebody will. flyfishingbover.com/TNLS6. And so I had a wily old vet tell me today that they struggled a little bit with the website because they kept adding to cart. Mm. The cart is in the top right of the website. So when you keep adding to the cart, you can just go up there and you just say, wow, I've entered 400, and then just click buy now. That's the best way to solve that problem, and they'll go away. They won't be in the cart anymore.
They'll just be on your credit card.
Wherever they go.
Whatever works.
All right.
Open your odds.
Okay, let's check back in at the baking cam. Because tonight was a pretty fun night before the show.
It was. The delicious brisket.
That was the delicious brisket.
Thanks to our friends at Friesen Brothers.
Yeah.
And then,
a little while later, after the smoker fried because of the snowstorm we had today, it got finished.
Another cooking
And then, in a super quick way, we're going to show you the finished product.
Oh, just like that.
Oh, does that not make your mouth water? I want to thank Friesen Brother for supplying this brisket. Not only did they supply it, they had it trimmed and ready to go for us. It's probably one of the most easy briskets that I've ever made. Quite simply, double music going there. That's a negative. Because I didn't have to trim it. I just seasoned it, dry rubbed it, let it sit for a day, and then threw it in the smoker. I mean, come on now. And then it was even easier for you. You just showed up and ate it.
I couldn't believe how easy it was for me.
Yeah.
Just enjoyed the flavor.
And then I think that there's a little bit left, and it's kind of goes something like that.
Ooh, that cream cheese over there?
That smoked cream cheese. We had so many good things.
I'm so full still. Crazy. No,
I'm just like looking at that.
So Dana,
yeah,
the dry rub, did you make it or was it pre-done?
A bit of both. There's a salt, pepper, garlic one that I used, but I mostly just did salt and pepper.
Okay.
And I find that's all you need.
Yeah. And the cheese is convenient. It's from under.
From under what?
From under.
From under your...
from under the cow.
Yeah, you could name it that.
Yeah, some people call it nut butter. Peanut butter.
Oh. It was good. Tasted delicious anyway.
All right. That's the folks upstairs. They've left it on the... That's all we got left for brisket. There's a lot of people in the house.
Yeah, there is.
And, yeah. That's kind of how that goes. Do you want to tie a fly? We can get the flies kind of out of the way, and then we can just hang out and have fun and be party animals.
Yeah, let's do that. I'm game.
Okay. Guys, second last fly of the season. Oh, look, they're moving the camera. Nope, they didn't. I was hoping they would. Nope, there they go. All right, so this is somebody. Who's this? There's a girl in the house?
Yeah.
Look at this, the party. We've got, look at all the desserts there. We've got pie from Linden. We've got some baking from Italian Center. Someone has purple nails, and that's not Troy.
It might be.
We've got the eternal camera. Look. I love the delay. There she is. Trisha's in the house. Okay. Well, there's Stephen Lyle, Triple Point Chemical.
What's happening?
He's our 0.5 guy. He's going to come down and give some reviews on the 0.5. So, all right, Tim. Well,
yeah, let's get at it. All right, folks. Hard to believe, but we are down to two flies. So let's get this caddis done and out of the way. This one is it's actually a really fun pattern. It is semi-similar to the Peterborough caddis, which we did a little earlier in the season. This one I think is actually maybe a little easier. Get to work with some hackle, get to teach you a little different technique for using the hackle this time with two different hackle. But it is quite small. We're tying this on a size 14 hook, so it's not overly large in any way, shape, or form, so it gets at times to be feels like a little crowded on the hook. But hopefully at the end it looks something like that. So let's go ahead and make sure you get your kit all open, get all your stuff arranged. This one is gonna actually go pretty quick. We're gonna be kind of getting through these flies in a timely manner tonight. So go ahead, get that out of the vise, get your next hook placed in. Get this one in here. So we do have a few materials, not a crazy amount. We're gonna be working with some foam, some hackle, some deer hair, and just a little bit of dubbing. It's not gonna be overly crazy in the material department. I am grabbing my UTC 70, and I'm using this kind of golden brown, bronzy color. So let's get that started just behind the eye of the hook. We're gonna work that down a little ways before we go in and trim out that tag end. We're gonna take this all the way back to the top of the hook bend. Right about there. So if I were to leave my bobbin hanging, it's gonna be roughly at the barb or just behind. And now the very first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna work with our dubbing. So we build the underside of the fly first, and then our foam goes up and over top. So you got a whole bunch of dubbing in here. This is a very fine dry fly dubbing, so we don't need a lot of it. But we are gonna try to make a semi-tapered dubbing noodle. So we want it to start a little thinner at the base of the noodle, and as we come down our thread, we're gonna make it a little bit thicker so that when we wrap it forward on the hook shank, we do get a little bit of a taper going. So I'm just gonna take a few light little pinches off. We're gonna come to our thread here. And as always, remember, it goes in the same direction with your fingers. You're not gonna go back and forth and like this. I put a little bit more on the chunk below. And I'll start with this if it isn't.
It's a, well, you got some dubbing in the next fly.
I do.
Just give one more for me.
I'll give you one tonight.
Just give me lots.
just give them lots.
Do it.
Okay, guys, so what we're going
to
do here.
Just tell them how to put dubbing on, Tim.
You're just going
to
put that dubbing on in one direction. Oh, that's what makes you beautiful. I'm going to savor it because I know it's going to be gone soon.
That's a good point. But why would you savor it? Just let it go.
Just let it go. Okay, so you want that to be a fairly tightly spun dubbing noodle, like so, okay? I'm gonna get these wraps started just back where that hook bend starts. I'm gonna make sure I get a nice little coating before I start wrapping forward. And again, remembering I am trying to work on a bit of a taper, so if I gotta go back and add a wrap or two. Now, as we're moving forward, we only wanna take this until about halfway up the hook, because we need to leave the remainder of the hook to do all the other work we have coming. So I'm gonna kinda go back up over top, create that little bit of a taper there, and I'll finish with my thread just in front of it. Just something like that, okay? If you have any little pieces that are kind of out and wonky, just the nature of this specific dubbing, just go ahead and get them out of the way. We're gonna go ahead and grab our 2 mil foam, okay? It's a nice tan 2 mil foam. What we do need to do though is we need it to be roughly the hook gap and width. So if I come and place this on the bottom and I slide it forward, you can see where the hook point goes into the foam. I suggest doing that and then taking a look from the bottom side, you can see where the little hole is. And we need to trim that much off because we want it to only be the width of the actual hook gap. So we're gonna take a little bit off because this foam is a little bit thick, or a little bit wide, I should say. So just trim that back for an inch and a half or two. That's enough for this fly. I'll go ahead and trim that portion off that I've trimmed. So we can kind of come back, we can double check it. Yeah, that's a lot better, a lot closer. Now, when I come up to the back end of this fly, what I want you to do is I want you to just take off just the corners. So we're gonna create a little bit of you know, that shape in the back end, so it's not just a blocky shape for the back end of this caddis. Now, when we're measuring this as to how far we want it to hang off the back, we're gonna say roughly half of that hook shank. So if I were to measure that kind of half right there, and I place that off the back of the hook bend itself. So again, if I measured there, mark that spot, and I hang it off the back of the hook bend, it's gonna be roughly where it's gonna be. So it's gonna hang off a little ways. At this point, I'm gonna hold that foam in place. I'm gonna grab a gathering wrap over top of that foam. I'm gonna start to pull down, take two more wraps, let my bobbin hang. I wanna straighten that foam out so it's right on top. And then I'm gonna put my fingers right over top where you're not gonna be able to see. I'm gonna pinch, and then I can pull that down and tighten that thread in the foam. Be careful not to go super, super tight on it, because if I do, the likelihood of actually cutting right through that foam is quite high with that thinner thread. But this is what we should be left with at the moment, okay? So then what I wanna do is lift this foam up. I'm gonna run my thread forward to just behind the eye of the hook. I'm gonna lay that foam back down. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take a couple of wraps up over top of that foam. I'm gonna go ahead again, pinch it, and pull tight. And now what I need to do is everything in between those two tying points needs to be flattened out. So I'm just gonna take some thread wraps over top, making sure that that foam stays centered and up on top of the hook shank. I'm just gonna work this down and flatten out all that foam so I can tie in all the other components of the fly. And I make sure I get this right up to the front there, like so. That's good. And now, instead of just leaving this big long piece of foam out front, I'm gonna come and just trim it down a bit so I know I'm gonna leave a little bit off the front, but I'm just gonna get that big chunk out of the way. And then I'm gonna bring my thread all the way back to right up against the back portion of the foam, where I'm gonna tie in some deer hair. So now let's go ahead and grab the deer hair that's in our kit. You're gonna have a patch that's gonna look something like this, okay? You wanna grab an ample amount, roughly half of a pencil width, something like that. By the time we stack it and pull out all the under fur, it's gonna make that stack quite a bit smaller. So we'll trim that off the patch. I'm gonna come and grab just the tips. You can see there's a bunch of under fur in there, so I'm gonna pull that out. You can see instantly that thins out the hair that we're doing or using. I'm gonna come up and find the points, and I'm gonna stick them in the hair stacker. And we're gonna give those a couple of good taps on the table to stack up those tips. Stack them up. And then when we go to pull the back end off, we want it to be pointed back and down the fly, as that's the direction we're gonna be tying in that hair. You can see our hair is nicely stacked. I'm gonna come in and pinch it between my fingers. I'm gonna kind of reorganize it in my hand. If I have any pieces that are kind of sticking out that are longer than others, I'm just gonna kind of prune those out right away. Now I wanna start coming and measure this tail. So I need this to extend just to the back edge of the foam. Now I would prefer to cut this hair first before I tie it in, so then that way I don't have to deal with a lot of the long butt end sticking up right away. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch hands. I'm gonna mark where my fingers are right here, so that's where I know I'm gonna make my cut. I'm gonna switch my hands over, like so, and I can come in and make my cut. And then all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tip that hair kind of at a 45 down onto that space that I created, slide it back slightly. Gonna give my bobbin a clockwise spin. For you right-hand tires, it would be a counterclockwise spin. Let my thread jump rearward and grab on top of those hairs. I'm gonna pull nice and tight. Make sure you can get all the hair in there. If it doesn't want to go for you, slip it forward just a bit. Redo your bobbin, spin, pull tight. Oh man, am I struggling. We're all human, folks.
No, you're not.
Doesn't want to cooperate. The hair is slippery. There we go. We want to do that. Once we pull tight on that hair, before I let go of it in my fingers, I want to drive some thread wraps into the butt ends of that hair. That's really gonna help secure it in place, and it's not gonna hopefully go anywhere. Cover all those butt ends up, and then when I let go of this, it should flare nicely, just like so. Up against that foam. Our length should be just about perfect, just hanging off the back slightly, that's great. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna prepare, we have two different hackles we're gonna tie into this one. So I'm gonna come in here, I have a brown hackle to start. I'm gonna come down to the end of it. I'm gonna, kinda like always, when I prepare a hackle. I'm going to peel off some of the bottom fibers off of that stem. You can see on this one, it's really obvious. The underside of the feather is kind of a light tan color, whereas the other side is a dark red color. We want the underside of the feather to be pointed towards the rear of the fly. When I tie this in, I can just lay it across right in front of that deer hair, secure that stem with a couple of wraps, come down the stem, make sure it's good and locked in there. I can flip that upside down. If I have any of that little bit of stem that's still sticking up, I'm just gonna go ahead and trim that out. Bring that back up, and now I'm gonna go to my other hackle. So you should have two in there. You're gonna have a grizzly hackle as well. I got my grizzly hackle right here. I'm gonna come in here, do the same thing. I'm gonna peel a few of those fibers off the stem, exposing that stem for as it is there. Underside of the feather again, pointed back down the fly. I'm gonna tie it in right on top of the other one. Make sure I get that stem good and secured, and then trim out any little bit that's left. I really like to bury my thread into that stem that's remaining, just so that it doesn't slip out on me, because that's always kind of the biggest fear. It'll really ruin what you have going on if that's the case. Now, unlike some of the other times, this pattern actually calls for adding a little bit more dubbing. So I'm gonna take just a very light wisp. I don't wanna add any more than enough to just basically color the thread. Make another little dubbing noodle. And this time we're just gonna be wrapping this right where we're gonna lay down the hackle in a moment here. Just enough to color the thread down against the front foam. Okay, just like that, nothing crazy. Now, the last thing we gotta do in here as far as materials is concerned is we gotta wrap our hackle forward. So this time, instead of going one at a time, I'm actually gonna grab both together, make sure I'm pulling even tension on both at the same time. I'm gonna come around, make sure I get one complete wrap right in front of the hair before I start slowly palmering forward.
Would it be better if you went halfway and then went back the other way?
What are you talking about?
When you wrap the hackle, how do you want to do it?
I'm getting set up again, but yes, you are going to do it in one direction. That's what makes you beautiful. Man, he just thinks I'm so beautiful.
I do. That's what makes you beautiful.
I'm going to keep wrapping forward. Once I get up to the front of that foam, I want to make sure I finish by pulling those two hackles straight vertical. I'm gonna come in and weave my thread around. I really don't wanna lock any of those hackle fibers down in the front, so I'm just gonna be very careful, make sure I get a thread wrap behind the stems and in front, and I need to repeat that process one more time. Just really work your thread through so it doesn't trap any of them. There we go. Now, before I do anything else, I wanna lift up the front. I wanna drive a couple of thread wraps right around the eye itself. And then I'm gonna come in with my half hitch tool, or you can whip finish, whatever you prefer. We're gonna put a couple knots in this before we do any trimming. So again, couple wraps around my half hitch tool, up over the eye of the hook, slide that down off the tool, gives me a good knot. I'm gonna repeat that again. Get my hackle out of there, there we go. Make sure that's tight, and then I can go in and trim out my thread. And then I can get my hackle out of the way here in a moment as well. I'll come in here. I'm gonna trim out my hackle. There we go, just like that. This is what I'll be left with at this point. And now the last thing I gotta do is just trim that front foam. So I just wanna leave just a little bit of foam there. I'm not trying to leave an excess at all. Basically enough to create, almost like on an elk or caddis, when you leave that little bit of front hair there, that kind of creates the same appearance. I'm gonna round off the corners of the foam. Just like that. If they got any more of those little fibers kind of sticking out and about, you can go ahead and trim them. But otherwise, that is what we're gonna call our Never Sink Caddis. And if you can't guess why it never sinks, well, we've got a great combination of, not only do we have deer hair, we have foam, What is that? That is...
Don't say I don't ever feed you.
He feeds me. Actually, quite often.
Oh, wow. Things go
weird.
They
say one of the most romantic things you can do is actually wash someone's hair. And you do it for me all the time.
How do you be romantic with me, then?
Well, I'm just a taker.
Be my...
Anyways, this is... that is your Never Sink Caddis. Thanks, buddy. That is a delicious looking pile of something. I don't know, but I like it.
Oh.
That's our Never Sink Caddis. Very great pattern. I love it. I got to fish this last year quite a bit, as well as the Peterborough. I love this so much. Great for fishing the riffles. Doesn't sink easily, obviously.
It actually never sinks.
It never sinks. It never sinks. I wish I could say that, but it sinks sometimes.
Look at that stuff. That is so good.
It's a little early tonight for this much sugar.
That's so good.
Just whipped cream and chocolate pudding, pretty much.
I think so. I think that's the pie that came from the guy in Linden.
Oh, man. That is
fantastic. Oh, Svenja! Tim, switch mics. We're going to do a quick couch check. I think things have changed up here.
All right, let's do it. Couch check it
up. See how easy that is to do? Let's go check out who's on the couch. I can't find the button. There it is.
We're doing so good. Oh, man. Look at these. This couple.
Look at that.
Ah, Morning View Mercantile. It's Cloodle
Doodle.
Cloodle Doodle.
I've been working out.
I think you stole Tim's workout regimen.
Yeah. It fits him almost as good as it fit me.
Yeah. You just work on the upper pecs. You got to work on the sag.
It's amazing.
Working on the sag, yeah.
Yeah.
What are you drinking?
I have a Hocktail Amber Ale.
Is that from Crappier Nation?
You bet it is.
That's right. That's where we get all our beers from, Crappier Nation. And they're in the house. They're in the house. Dave and Tiff are in the house.
We're going to get them on the couch.
We're going to get them on the couch. This couch is a revolving door.
Yep.
Colin, what are you drinking?
I have Field and Forage Marshmallow Porter. This is my favorite beer.
Yeah. Really?
I love this beer. Picked it up at Craft Beer Nation today.
Oh, yeah.
Although we do quite often go actually to Field and Forage. Innisfail. And if you go on the right day, they even float a roasted marshmallow on top of your marshmallow porter.
Wow, nice. Mm-hmm. Why would any fly fisherman be in that area?
I can't
there's
imagine.
There's no reason. There's no rivers. There's no
nothing.
Creeks.
Nothing.
It's on the way.
No spring creeks.
It's nothing to be. Nothing there. Nothing to see here.
That's my hometown.
Nothing to
Born
see
there. Born
and
raised.
There. Yeah.
I know all the good spots in Innisfail.
That's Born and why. Raised and got out.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah. Well, they do say the top thing to do in Olds on a Friday night is
visit the old folks' home.
Is leave.
The name.
Is leave. They say the top thing to do in Olds, Alberta, Canada, on a Friday night is leave.
Huh. I mean, it makes sense.
I did an Ipsos poll with me and my family. I came back strong, 4 out of 4.
Just leaving.
Voted. Is that why they call it Timnisfail now?
Yeah. They do.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
I had heard that. I heard that.
Timnisfail.
When we were at the Timnisfail co-op earlier, they were mentioning it.
I used to work at that co-op. I managed the bakery.
Obviously, it was
and the meat.
It was the Tim-op. Tim. You were in there with the meat?
I was. I just slapped that
the
hammer
The Timnisfail Co-op. Shaved have you guys it. Been to the Timnisfail Tim Hortons?
Yeah, I have.
Did you see what I did there? It's a double entendre. I used the word Tim twice.
Don't use your big fancy words. Entendre.
Just to make you feel important. Being from Timnisfail.
I feel special.
Can't wait for the shirt.
Yeah.
I know.
I'm from Timnisfail.
Right on.
Alberta.
Because that's actually where our kitchen is for Morning View Mercantile.
That is right.
Where is it?
Timnisfail.
Oh.
Yep.
That's crazy.
Right beside where Tim used to work, right beside the co-op.
Oh. The
Which
the,
way?
Oh, that's weird.
Like in the same
between
building?
The co-op and the Tim's. Yeah.
Yeah
right
in
the
that,
same building.
It's in that mall.
Is it? Yep. Oh, okay.
Guys, for so long, I've been driving right by Timnisfail because it wasn't on the map until Tim was
it's
born.
It's on now.
Yeah. It's there
And
now.
Then it's on the map and I was checking my GPS and I was like, wow.
Just showed up, popped up.
This place called Innisfail for like a week, and then they named it Timnisfail.
Yeah, good for them.
So that's a bunch of useless facts that you get when you tune in, and those are free.
Yeah, but you couldn't charge for them. So.
Yeah, well, we could. You just wouldn't pay for them. Well, the good news is this is still live.
Still live. You're running out of time, though.
You are running out of time. And so maybe you bought 4 tickets. Maybe you bought 10 tickets. Maybe you want to buy some more because, hey, you're just feeling really lucky right now. And you want to, like, pay us for the Timnisfail fact.
Yeah.
Like, we
Don't
said
say
they
that.
Wouldn't pay for it, but maybe they do want to pay for it. I'm watching the orders come in. I'm putting them into the program right here, hoping everything works out smooth.
Yes. Smooth. It has so far.
Until earlier today when the whole sound and the...
Don't bring up that bad stuff. It's going to work.
Let's say thanks to our sponsors.
Let's do it.
And we'll be right back.
All right.
In the heart of nature, when hunger strikes and time is of the essence, Morning View Mercantile has the solution. Witness how we redefine convenience. It's not just a meal, it's an experience. In mere moments, a feast emerges. Delight in the flavors of the wilderness. Morning View Mercantile, your partner in adventure, your ally in taste. For every adventure, a memorable meal. Morning View Mercantile, where every bite is an expedition.
Being up in the high Rockies or up in that area, the different species, right? Still looking to get a brookie under the belt, still looking to get a bull under the belt, but you know, the fish are amazing, and just the landscape is second to none.
All right, good folks, what's happening? Cody, Frankie, better late than never. How about Saturday? I said, Cody, what's happening? You excited to see your film? He said, cool. What film? I said, the one you're in. He said, where? Why?
Today.
Why would I be in a film? Anyways,
I think you forgot.
We go to the theater. He's got cardboard cutouts of Cody, Frankie, and he's got pen and signed. He's signing autographs, and he pretended he didn't know about it.
Yeah, he's just acting so cool.
Yeah, he's got
so cool.
And then I got a call from his agent later.
Yeah.
Apparently, he didn't get paid enough.
Well.
And then he pretends
you got
he doesn't
paid?
Know. Speaking of things that didn't go well.
Speaking of double entendre. Well, that was... kits have got so much better. That's all I can say.
Well, that's what I wanted to talk about.
Yeah.
Let's see, we'll roll into this scene given the fact that we have more friends on the couch.
Oh, who's this?
Well, we have Miss Timnisfail and Junior Timnisfail.
We got them all in the house.
There you guys, your mics are unmuted.
All my ladies.
As seen before, Ren Hepworth.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
What's happening? This couch is just revolving. Why don't you guys tell us a little bit about who you are, where you're from, and how it feels to be named after Timnisfail?
Well, we're from a town called
Timnisfail.
No.
Oh.
Okay,
but, okay. Timcomb.
Yeah, Timcomb. We're from Timnisfail.
Oh, nice.
And my name is Ren.
Yeah.
And I guess I am Timnisfail Jr.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're very bright, too.
Yeah. So, Mama, your turn.
My turn. I'm the other person. I'm the other Hepworth. My name's Trish. You guys never see me, and that is very intentional.
Oh, she's
sly. I'm always supportive from the background, but when you guys are doing call-ins from New Zealand, I'm in the background.
Fun.
Collins from
Yeah.
Costa Rica, I'm in the background.
She's holding the phone.
trying to get us in line for other things. Fun story, I don't think anyone realizes this, but when Tim and I first got together, he did not fly fish.
So you taught him everything.
He didn't actually start fly fishing until after Ren was born. So this is a fairly new obsession, and our marriage has evolved around this obsession. But I will admit that my obsessions have also changed over the course of a 10-year marriage. So we're even in that regard. But
that's true.
Yeah.
It's very true.
Has it been 10 years or will it be 10 years?
It will be 10 years.
Well,
we'll be
marriage 10 years.
Marriage.
Married 10 years.
What's
September.
That?
Yeah.
If you're still watching, Janine, we're going to hit day zero soon. Not to bring up age or anything, but you have a milestone birthday this year?
I do.
Yeah, 40.
60. Yeah. 60.
Cougars. Am I right?
Tim is a cougar hunter.
Well, so when Tim went and got on the chopper in New Zealand and was like, hey, I'm going to take off for 3 days, I was like, yeah, that sounds amazing. Go have a cool adventure. But just so you know, when you get back, for my 40th, we're going to get on a chopper and go do something I want to do.
And so what are you doing? Fishing?
We're going to go backcountry heli hiking, but he thinks it's hiking, but it's going to be mostly running.
Yeah, I've been duped into these
before.
These hikes.
These fast hikes.
Fast-packing hikes where you're going to gain like a few thousand feet of elevation.
Yeah. Lose some LBs.
Yeah.
Fine.
Well, I think we'd be remiss if we didn't say a huge thank you to you and Ren, because the show takes Tim away from Tim Nisfail and Tim Combe. So you lose him at least once a week to come down here and sit at the Vice and to, you know, be a big part of everybody's Thursday night. So I'm sure we can all give a round of clicks to Miss Hepworth and Junior Hepworth.
Yes, well, thank you for coming and joining the couch tonight.
You're welcome.
Making it down,
welcome.
Driving the roads.
All right. Did you guys get your tickets yet, Ren?
Yeah, go get mom. Maybe
I know
buy
we
some
were
tickets.
We were concerned we weren't allowed to, but
yeah, I was gonna say they're like because
I think
she did
rules,
win a
don't know.
I won this.
She won that shirt at the film festival last weekend.
Good thing I wanted to bring up. Okay?
I had nothing to do with that.
Some straight up nepotism there.
I might have gotten in trouble. The first year we did our Oman film, I was like, first person to join the live stream wins. And so Matea joined and I was like, I can't pick. And I was reminded of that because Ren won right away.
Right, first one.
So anyways, it was rigged.
Everyone's very supportive. All the families are supportive.
Yeah. Sure, it looks great. Okay, folks, let's tie the other fly, and then we're going to come back.
Yeah.
You still got about 10 to 20 minutes, about 20 minutes to get your tickets in, and we're going to tie a fly. We're going to tie the Circus Peanut Hopper in a shade of pink, and then we're going to come back to this program called Who Wants to Be a $17,000 an Heir? Should we let people call a friend? You know, I wondered about getting a little cutthroat. But the fact it's not free, I'm playing nice. You know what I mean?
But keeping the claws away.
Yeah, the wizard.
That would be cruel.
Dropping the trapdoor.
Because you guys. So John Onorati texts me today. He's like, "Okay, I have searched my box high and low. Is there anything secret that you guys put in there this year?" And I said, "No." It's like, dude, be serious with me. Am I missing something? So. As we know, there definitely is a little bit of a twist coming up. As usual, the prizes tend to get better and better and better, but not today. We mixed it up a bit, but we did save a really good one for right near the end. Stick around.
Right, he's gave me back my mic.
I was like, why are you talking?
It's like, because that one was muted and this one was too, so I had nothing. All right, guys, let's do the Circus Peanut Hopper. So this one we're going to be tying in a real fun color scheme. We're going to be doing it in this pink and tan version. As we know, trout like pink, they like purple. How they see these colors is different than how we do under the, in the water. Well, I guess if we were under the water, we'd see them the same, but differently. So we're gonna do this one in pink. This is what it looks like. It's actually a super easy foam fly to tie. It's not something that's an overly complicated one, so we're gonna take you through it pretty quick. And thank you for my beer back. And we'll go from there. So let's go ahead, we'll get our hook and our vise. So we're tying this on a little bit smaller hook than we may normally do, but we're gonna extend the size of the pattern a bit outside the reaches of the hook itself. This is a size 10 streamer hook that we're gonna be tying this on. Could do it on a nymph sprout hook as well. Anything that's a little heavier gauge. I am tying with UTC 140 in this nice pretty pink. Doesn't look very pink there, but it is very pink. Looks better when it's on the hook itself. We're gonna start our thread just behind the eye. We're gonna work it back and down. This is our last fly of the season. This is a really weird feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I know, it's just like, I wanna go real slow, one wrap at a time.
Well, we haven't had the opportunity for me to dictate or rate.
Oh, it's true. Let's do it. Let's do it right now. Are you ready?
I think I remember this fly. I was just too busy. Okay, so.
You're not going to hear any more from me.
What happens here, guys? Because truly, on the final episode, you're probably not tying along with us. You're probably just having a couple drinks. And the quick ties are there. And what are the quick ties? Quick ties are pre-recorded videos that Tim teaches you how to tie this fly. So you don't have to stress if things don't go well. On the live stream, you know what I'm saying? Okay, so we haven't done it this year, but what we've done in the past and we're going to do now is I am the voice of Tim. I'm gonna hide myself. Do I hide myself?
I think you have to. Nobody can see you.
Okay, can't see me.
Yeah.
So I hide myself. And you can't see me. And now I walk you through this fly. All right. So what we're going to do here is we're going to get back to the barb of the hook. And Tim got me. I got you. That one is for Tiffany. You've been got. You've been had. So at this point, what I typically do is I get back to this bend of the hook here. You can see the barb. And I'm just going to grab some of this fine dubbing, and it is pink in nature. You can also tie this fly. Hang on a sec. I got to turn off your boom because it's echoey. Now I get a little more intimate with the folks. So what we're going to do here, folks, is on this dry fly dubbing, you can use a lot of different kind of dubbings. You can even get some dubbings that are sparkly. But the biggest thing that we got to remember is when we're putting on that dubbing, we got to make sure we only go one direction. That's what makes you beautiful. And so what we're going to do is we just kind of want an even body here. So hey now, I'm the voice of Tim Hepworth. Tim is fail. Okay, so we're just doing a little bit of an egg. This could be an egg sack if you want. We're just going to wrap that dubbing. We're going to come back. What's cool about the thread is that it matches closely to our dubbing. So if we're an average fly tire like myself right now, we're not going to have a problem. So what we've done, we just dubbed a bit behind. We're going to get a piece of foam, true 2 mil foam. Okay, this is true 2 mil, and we're going to space it out. If you have the materials that we've cut for you, you're going to have exactly this. And you're going to go just a little bit longer than the shank of the hook. And that's kind of up to you. Because actually, if you want to go a little bit longer than longer, you can make this fly pop and gurgle a little bit. And sometimes that helps fish take a strike. But now the fact that we're going to double this up, we're going to cut that in half, and you're going to get a double. So we have the Never Sink Caddis. We could pretty much call this the Never Sink Circus Peanut Hopper. Because it's going to be so full of foam, you're going to think it was a poorly poured beer, right? And then we're going to taper the top, and this is the not the top, this is the tail, right? So both pieces of foam are tapered just like this. And poorly tapered, but hey, tapered... Tapered is tapered. And we're going to stick those two pieces of foam. We're going to double up like we were in some shady bar in Montana. And we're going to throw those just about there. But we're going to go back about 1.5 the shank of the hook. And when we get to a point where our nails don't look good, but our foam does, we're going to secure that with what we're going to call a securing wrap. We're going to come back here with a little bit of collecting wrap. And by collecting, I mean we're going to collect the thread. And then we're going to tighten down. We're going to squeeze that. It's why you want a bit thicker of a thread so you don't cut the foam. Okay? Remember, foam is home. We do not want to cut the home. To cut the foam. Okay? All right. So that's basically the point here. And now we're going to tie in one of our white legs with black stripes on them. Okay? You can do black legs with white stripes. It doesn't matter. You just have to kind of know the fish in your local area. And we're going to take two of them. We're going to split them right down the middle. Okay? It's kind of ASMR if you were to hear the sound of rubber legs splitting. And then we're going to take two of them. Now that they're split, we're going to lick our fingers. And we're going to stick them. We're going to pull them up. Okay, you're going to go to your thread about that much. Okay? That much. If you go more than that much, you're going to have a problem. You know, this little trick wrapping rubber legs. You're going to go around and you're going to suck it back in. You're going to wrap one more time in the front of it. And then you're going to wrap one more time in the front of it. So that's two times total in the front of it. So now we've got two sets of legs. You're going to weasel one of those legs to the near side of the camera. Right there. And you're going to split the foam. Okay, foam is home, folks. You are going to split the foam. Okay, so now you've got two legs splayed perfectly and you're happy. And you're happy. And you're going to stretch those legs just to make sure that they didn't dry out sitting there waiting for episode 13. All right. Essentially, that's where we're at. We're going to go back there and we're going to grab the Care Bear dubbing and we're going to put it back onto our thread. Being very careful, folks. Some people would like to go like Ted and pinch his barb because sometimes that barb gets hooked up on the thread and then you pull a cam and you break your thread. And sometimes you can use a little bit of wax if you want, okay? Wopsy makes a good premium. It's actually not good, it's premium dubbing wax. And that's kind of up to you, okay? You decide how much wax that you want to use. And then you're going to put that dubbing on quite simply in one direction. Oh, that's what makes you beautiful. And I can play that as long as I want because I have the button. And you're just going to keep... But all jokes aside, it's really important that you don't go back and forth because that dubbing will just noodle right off there. So you're going to make this noodle what Tim would consider about 9 inches, but it's about 3 inches. Okay, it's a little more than a roll of dimes, but it's not quite 9 inches. And remember, you can always pull the dubbing off and you can always put on more. So you don't have to be perfect. You just have to be present. Presently trying to tie this fly. And now you're making the body, the underbody, a nice bright pink underbody. And you're going to keep wrapping that thread until the dubbing starts. So we don't see any of that thread. All right, just like that. You don't need to taper this thing. You just need to build some bulk on the body. So that 9 inches that Tim tied up there might not be enough. He might have to put some more on. But it got real thick and bulbous at the end. And it looks like it's just about to make it perfect. He's done this before, and that's why it's perfect. Given the fact that this is the 26th pattern, and it's not quite perfect, so he's going to add just a little bit just a little bit more on there until he gets almost to the eye of the hook. And then he's going to bring that foam back down one at a time. Not two at a time like he did the back. He's kidding. He's doing it just like the back. We're going to do it just like the back. And then you want to do that collecting wrap, kind of seat that into the foam. And that is true 2 mil foam right there, folks. It's not 1.97. That is factory approved true 2 mil foam. And then just going to get a couple, 3 or 4 wraps there. You don't want to overdo those wraps. I mean, like a really good fly tire would probably put a little dubbing on those wraps. But an average fly tire is just going to leave it as it is. And then throw things at people. But that's okay. We're average. And then we got to see these other two legs. We got three here. We're not making a three-legged, front-legged stone circus peanut, hopper, Chernobyl. We're going to go down to two. You got lots of legs in there, okay? Use your legs generously. And then again, we're going to split these legs apart. We're going to pull them. Okay, we're going to make them stretch. Did we lose our audience here? I think everybody's just mesmerized and they're tying along. Okay, so the same thing as the back. Basically, this is what we call a repeating pattern. The same in the back, the same in the front. Okay, Not like a mullet where it's party in the back, business in the front. This one here is just a buzz cut. It is the same in the back as it is the front. Okay, wrap those legs around, go on top just like this, couple collective wraps. A good fly tire would throw some dubbing on that thread, but hey, average is best. And then we're going to pull the rubber legs down to the side. You see that? Down to the side. And that's quite simply just to give a little bit of activation to this fly. Okay, Suzanne's here. Got her tickets. That is a fact. She did for sure. And the draws are coming up soon. So now, folks, what happens when you're out there is you can't see. Okay, so we do what we call a cider foam, a little piece of orange. You can use a hole punch to get a nice round one, or you can just roughly cut it just like that. A little bit of a triangle. Now we're going to have a lot of waste on this, but that's okay. We got lots of true 2 mil foam. Okay. And see all the foam? That's triple layered foam. That thing is almost going to be better than the Never Sink Caddis. So same methods apply. We just wrap that around and then we just do a little bit of a half hitch here. And we're drunk, so we cannot get the eye of the hook like we want it to do. And quite simply, guys, the sad part is someone's in the studio playing the live stream back on their phone and I can hear it. And I'm going to email them a punch in the dick. And then we just cut it off. Okay. If you want, you could take a little bit of super glue. You can dab a little dabble, do you? Okay. I wouldn't worry about it. But if you want, you just got to put your lid back on your wax so it doesn't dry out. And then next time you need it. Now we got all these legs. And remember the fact about the legs is you can't add any more on the legs, but you can cut more off. So always carry a pair of scissors in the boat on your hip. Sometimes I just leave the Chernobyls this big. And then I go in there and decide, hey, do I just want to get shorter legs? And then I just cut them. And then sometimes I'm like, hey, do I just want bigger legs? And I can't grow them, right? So you just probably should keep the distance between the back and there is kind of where we want to be the same in the front. Because you got to trim up that foam. And like I said, folks, it's like a buzz cut. It's the same in the back as it is the front. So make sure that we got equidistance all over the place. Because the tricky part about this is the fish doesn't know if this fly is coming or going because it's the same in the front as it is the back. And that is the best way to trick a fish is there's no front and there's no back. So they don't have to inquire about weird things like, hey, am I going to eat you from behind? Because... both are equal. And that's about how we're going to cut the legs. Like I said, you cannot grow legs. You can just cut legs. So to finish off episode 13 and the 26 fly pattern that we've done so together, Tim, and we've, that's sad. Peace. Oh boy, I think the joke just resonated in the outer parts because I don't know who, I think that was Colleen laughing about that joke. That's kind of how it went. And they're sitting in there. So if they are in the other studio, somebody could go touch the screen of that camera and then the thing will come off. But what do I know? You want your mic back?
Nicely done, Dan.
Well done, Timothy. That is 26 patterns.
Crazy.
And round Crazy. Of clicks. Round of clicks, everybody. Round of clicks.
Yeah. You did it. You made it through a season of flies.
Huh.
Maybe.
My Harry mic Albert. Tuning in. You need to start narrating one fly every episode. Yeah.
It is fun. I like it.
It is fun. But I had a lot of stuff I was supposed to do in the meantime, and I didn't get done. But that's okay, folks. We are so fast. It is only 8:10 Mountain Standard Time.
I'm doing pretty good.
We got so much time on our hands.
Always.
Well, you know what they say.
If you're not eating pie.
If you're not eating pie, you're not that guy.
So good.
It's so good. It's unreal.
I remember one time the season started and this quagmire of folk was on the couch and they're back.
Tim, I think you have to eat that pie from the other side.
Oh, so pie's directional?
Well, it's better to eat pie from the back.
It looks like the pie was just flopped on the plate. It could go, you don't know whether it's coming or going.
I think they like threw it off the roof and they ran around and caught it.
Well, we kept the bottom of the plates clean this time, though.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And they're like, we're just going to go feed it to the guys.
That is so good.
What's up, boys?
Howdy.
It has been since episode zero that the three of you have been together. You guys actually are the OG. You guys started the couch.
We were the first on the casting.
Yeah.
Christening.
You christened it. Yeah. Adrian, you've been working out, I see.
That shirt's making its rounds.
That's the other one.
Oh, that's mine. Claude, that one's mine.
Claude's got the other one.
Hey, yeah. Hey, don't pull a Barry Dick out here.
I thought you were going to say, don't pull something out.
A roll of dimes. I'm Ken enough.
Just enough.
This kind of stuff could be our screenshot of the night.
I think it is.
All right, is it? Yeah, okay, folks, what we do here is we do the screenshot of the night. I just made it up. We've done it like twice. So now it's a thing moving forward. We give you the best pose we can give you. We got to do this because we're vertical.
Or what?
Oh.
Hey, guys, get in and pose and hold. Screenshot it, folks. Take a photo. Everybody hold on. We've got 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, send us the photo. Yeah.
That's how we count.
It's kind of a thing. It's kind of a thing we do.
Yeah, that's how we count fish over here.
Yeah.
What did you catch? 5, 6, 4?
12.
Cam, tell me something.
Something.
From the first day you sat on the couch to now.
Yeah.
It's been pretty good, eh? And for yourself?
It's been a battle, actually. Geez, when was that? That was
December.
So yeah, I've had some ups and downs. It seems like not that long ago. Yeah, no, it's been it's had the longest.
As I told Barry, your voice sounds better in the microphone.
Okay, well,
a microphone.
There it is. I was out of work for a while, and then last month or so, I've been back at work, so it's been awesome. It's been one of those kind of springs that it didn't seem like it was going to end, and now I'm looking forward to summer and, you know, shenanigans. That's normal. Waiting for
one
the goat
more
rodeos.
Storm.
Yes,
one more snowstorm away.
We are, but goat rodeos can't come soon enough. No. So it's been one of those winters. It's been all over the map. So, but yeah, like last weekend was like the tippy top, like hanging out with everybody at
I-4. We didn't even talk about I-4. Man, that was epic.
Ken ditched. It was crazy.
He had to go play the pond.
So. Adrian was like doing something like work.
Busy doing his hair for the night.
People looking after family stuff over here. That was awesome. It was so awesome to meet a ton of new people and tons of old people. Well, not old people, but old
well,
friends.
Well, Ken was there.
There was a few older people. I mean, what can you say about this group? I mean, how many years now? It's 6. Yeah. And what, that's year 3 for tracks and for the I-4 up here?
Yeah, it's third year I-4.
Third year Film Fest.
Like and it keeps getting better and more people. I mean, packed again this year, which was fantastic. So it was good. Roger McDonald, what do you have to say?
You pretty much covered it, man. Winter's been awesome. You know, Tim and Dana getting us through it. Can't wait for the spring. It's coming soon. Got about a foot of snow to melt off, dirty up the water, and DTMs might come out.
Adrian?
Yeah, the days felt long, but the years and months are feeling short. Chasing 2 toddlers around and working full time, so it's a pretty crazy show.
It looks like you've been finding some time to get to the gym, so.
Yeah.
Man, I can't stop looking at his belly button. That's your
that's what everyone says.
It's just so big.
It looks like one of those monkey shirts that's whistling.
Battle. Yeah. It's so dark and it's like a cave.
You gotta buy me a drink if you're gonna touch it.
Cave of goodness.
I feel intimidated holding this big mic. Take this.
Somebody's too
big. You don't like big black mics?
No, I'm not used to something that big.
Roll a dime. It all started here. It all started here.
The cord.
Oh man.
Oh god.
Look at you guys, the three of you. Freaking frack.
Yeah. So comfy together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just as warm as I remember.
I got some Korean K-pop playing.
Yeah, we can hear that.
Oh, where's Aaron? We need him here today.
Guys, we're about to do the giveaway.
The giveaway? You mean all 31 of
all
two 30, of them?
32.
32 of them?
32. And you guys are here.
Yeah.
I gotta check to see if some more came in. Oh shoot. What was that? Okay, wrong keyboard, wrong button. In the meantime, between time. Let me check.
Check it, check it. What?
Check your head.
I can't believe how many people came out tonight.
Oh, that's awesome.
Unbelievable.
Big crowd upstairs.
Yeah.
It's Korean K-pop.
What? That's who you're listening to.
That's what we're listening to.
I know. I didn't realize. I was like, "What do you?" I thought you could hear something else.
Yeah, I was.
I was like, "I don't hear it. What are you hearing?"
I thought you lost something.
Yeah, I lost my mind. Waiting for the website to load.
Ah.
Oh jeez. Yeah. Well. OGs. All right.
You're saying the OGs.
Okay. So I got some work to do, and don't know what to do. Tim, tell a joke.
Someone.
I had a good one. I was gonna write it down too.
I got a riddle.
You had a riddle?
I got a riddle.
Okay, let's hear it.
It's a three-letter word that starts with gas. It's a good riddle, eh? Come on, three-letter word that starts with gas.
Gas?
Car.
There you go. You win.
Oh, yes. Oh man.
Never. Never, ever, ever.
Wow.
You're so good.
What's happening? Why are the comments coming in? You guys see this? We're going
to... Well, I tried to see it, then I got in trouble because my phone was loud.
Well, it's loud. It's loud.
It's live still on Facebook,
huh? Oh, there's comments here. Share it. Share it, folks. If we get 150 people in here tonight, we'll do the giveaways. If not, we're just...
Can we just give them away in this room?
Yeah. Great odds in here right now.
Pretty decent.
Oh, see what that roll of dimes will buy you. Oh, man. Where's Doug? Doug's got to be in the house. He's going to have a joke for us.
We don't have one of these. Also, yeah, we got to put...
Yes.
So we're slowly building on what Dane's doing here is taking a Polaroid. If you're ever on the couch, you come in and you're on the couch, you get your Polaroid, and you can see behind the guys there in the OQP, currently in the queue, is where all the Polaroids from everyone who's been in the couch and who visit are getting their Polaroids put in there. So
in the queue.
Come in to the couch queue. Next year and get your photo taken. Hang out with us.
Come to the couch, not on it.
Yes.
Oh, well. Either or.
I'm alive and there's children out there.
Yeah. Cameron.
I can't be... anywhere. This is why I type stuff, because kids can't read.
Yeah. He's out.
You're kicked off of Facebook again.
Yeah. How do I get shadow banned from the couch?
All right. Why are the comments not refreshing here?
It's so refreshing.
Tim, you have a favorite fly out of this season?
Oh, good question.
You talk about it. I got to enter a bunch of stuff here.
It's good. And it's a good conversation, too, because... What we do need to talk about is I'm not going to give you any input into next year's flies because they're done. But the following year, we do need input. And so we've had some guys, even IF4.
We had lots of input this year. That's where they came from.
I know. You know what I'm talking about. But Ted, even this weekend, he was talking about some great suggestions. We're very open to it. The show is an evolving thing, as you can see. It always changes every year. So, we like input on flies. But if I were to choose a fly this year... I'm going to go two categories. My favorite one to fish, but my favorite one to tie. So, favorite one to fish.
Okay, well, before you do that, let's take...
You're going to take a vote on...
Take a vote on that.
Take on the favorite to fish.
I would say... I'm going to say...
Here's your microphone.
The BBD. I would say favorite to fish. It's going to be... Circus Peanut Topwater eats all day long.
Not that one.
I'm gonna go with Thin Mint.
He's got it. That's it. Favorite
you
to fish.
You haven't felt that. It's like a Volkswagen hit your line.
It's amazing.
Like there's nothing, then all of a sudden, hang on.
And then by far my favorite, and we do a few every year, and try to keep you guys engaged for those of you who enjoy the salt water. But Kung Fu Crab, it's my favorite to tie. I love tying the crabs, any saltwater pattern, but the crabs are super fun. I really enjoy them. So that's that was my favorite to tie by a long shot. How about you boys? What was your favorite to tie this year?
I can't answer because I watch and call.
Yeah, he doesn't tie.
Broken thread again.
I ran out of thread a long time ago.
What about you there, Ken?
I think my favorite to tie was maybe the slum hop, any of the foams.
Yeah.
Because I'm brutal with foam, but this year I seem to kind of do a little jump and they got fun.
Yeah. Foam's an interesting one because once you kind of like get that little bit of learning curve under your belt, I find like it'll just like click. It's like wrapping hackle or working with deer hair. When 100%. It all of a sudden works, it's like,
This is easy. Tie a million of them.
Tie a lot of them. Yeah. For sure. What about you, Adrian?
The hair is your parachute.
Yeah.
I kind of like classic sort of looking flies.
Yeah.
It's a tough one, but it's a lot of fun.
Definitely. Yeah, the parachutes are good this year. We had a few of them. And I agree. I really like the parachutes. As a dry fly, I think they're one of the more simple ones to tie. They're not super, super complicated. So great, great pattern. A lot of great flies this year. A lot of really useful flies. So some suggestions have been or questions have been like, well, which of these can I fish on the bow or which of these can I fish on my home water? And the answer is all of them, really. I mean, outside of the, maybe excluding the saltwater patterns, try them all. I mean, we don't just randomly pick these out of a hat. Like, we do a lot of research and a lot of them are pulled from ones that we have fished a lot. We're not really advertising when these are like, hey, these are the guide fly that we use every day, but you're tying them. I can promise you they're in there. So some great, great, great patterns this year and a lot of good ones coming next year.
Pike will hit a Kung Fu crab.
Oh, yeah. Sure. And a goldeye, without a doubt.
Man, I fished the snow cone on the river the other day. I mean, I didn't catch anything on anything, so it didn't matter what I was fishing.
Definitely.
I tried it out, right?
Yeah. And it's the best way to correlate data on your tying. And, I mean, there are people who just tie to tie, and that's awesome. But when you're tying to fish, you just mess with patterns. Maybe the snow cone, you change the bead color, you change the wrap color. Maybe it looks more like a zebra midge or whatever. But yeah, you go down those tracks until you find patterns that work for you, and that's kind of the fun part about fly tying.
What's the main difference between a Perdigon and a Comminid?
A Perdigon. So Perdigon is actually a fly that's been designed by tightline nymphers or Euro nymphers, where you have a lot of weight at the bottom. So often they're tied with tungsten beads. Not often. They should be tied with tungsten beads. They're tied on a jig hook normally.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, they're the most simple patterns. They can look beautiful to tie still, but they're so, so simple mayfly patterns and they just work.
Oh, like, yeah.
It's crazy. Had a couple clients this year actually like wanting to fish their own flies and the Perdigon was one of their favorites. And I don't fish a lot of Perdigons, but I'm telling you, man, it was crazy.
Yeah.
And then you were really wishing you had a lot of them in your box. <'cause> Now everybody in the group wants one, but, yeah, that's kind of the main difference, right? So, yeah.
We're getting close, folks. We're going to give about another... Let's do this. You guys keep talking.
I think we need to do one more Guide's Corner.
Ooh. Oh.
But you don't have to do it. I can do it.
Eight lucky guys coming to guide school.
That's all I have is Guide's Corner.
That's all you have.
Well, I didn't even... That in the computer part.
Of it. I didn't even the whole entire show.
Tie flies this year.
You narrated one. That was pretty good.
That was good.
We should whoever had that comment, but you should do one episode. Even if that's been much, at least once every other one.
Once
maybe.
A month.
Once a month.
Yeah. I give Tim the mouse to do the computer
stuff. I'll just click whatever I want. Yeah, I agree. Not a bad idea.
Are comments coming in? Like,
it's there is the odd one coming in. Still coming in.
Okay.
That was a big guy's thumb.
All right. This is what we're gonna do. Did you have something to rant?
No, I was just giving you the opportunity to tell me to rant.
I'm caught up.
You're caught up well.
I think I'm going to challenge somebody and some people here go and make sure that's...
We're going to fight?
Yep.
Indian leg wrestle. Oh, yeah. No.
Coconut. Go get some of that brisket grease.
Oh, yeah, just slather up.
Okay.
Wow.
You're my boy, Blue.
Where did my song go? I had a really good song in here.
Oh, oh you did.
Fire.
Nope, that's not definitely going to do it. Nope, that's not going to do it. All right, 2.5 minutes. I don't know where the Facebook people are. This is like very romantic music. And this point of this slide is to get a little bit angry. So I'm gonna find a song. We're just killing some time here. Make sure that's not a .00. Guide's Corner. I don't have anything to talk about. Tim needs lipstick tonight. That's what the comment is. Okay, so on this segment of the show, I rant. You guys give me something to rant about, and I do. And I got a minute and 35. And while I wait for you, I'm drinking this called Kuma Outdoor Gear Lazy Bear Blonde Ale. So it's a collab with Kuma Outdoor Gear and Alley Cat. And I'm going to give it a try. From our friends at Craft Beer Nation, who supplied all of our drinks this year, I've got 1 minute and 17 seconds to do a bit of a Guide's Corner rant. And I'm not seeing the Facebook comments, guys. Where are they? What I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to turn on the Facebook here.
Just rant about Facebook.
We can redo this rant.
Yeah, everybody feels like they're not showing up on Facebook.
Yeah, I know. Have you heard? People are saying that?
Yeah. Bags just said, we aren't showing up on Facebook.
All right, you're going to have to head over to YouTube, folks, if you want to comment. More so, I just want to go in here and see if I can join the live stream. All right, I see it there. We've been commenting and it hasn't seen anything so hurt. What are things? Okay, so I got some rants here. So I like this. Okay, we're going to give you guys... Watch this. Just kidding, Ken. You're not getting played again. 2 minutes and 42 seconds. Hot Sauce John rant. YouTube. And honestly, guys, go over to YouTube if you want because your Facebook comments are not coming through to our screen here. That's why I've opened it up here. People rigging at the boat ramps. Yes.
Oh, that's a good one.
I think it's a good one. Facebook comment here. I'm on Facebook. And do zippers belong on waders? Yes, they do. What are things good clients should do? I think I'm going to do that and ruin my summer. How does the solar... What are things good clients should do? I got a minute and 58, and I'm not going to burn any bridges. But more so, what do good clients do? Good clients do this. They are real with their expectations, and their expectations are oftentimes met with the understanding of their skill level. So, if I hand somebody a fly rod within like 10 seconds, I'm pretty sure I can tell the skill level of somebody. And probably the people who talk less about their experience and their skill are probably the more skilled people. The people that talk about their skill level a lot tend to be the people that aren't really that good. So what does a good client do? A good client listens to their guide. And I don't mean that in an arrogant way. I just mean you've paid somebody pretty good money to take you fishing. And so why would you get on the boat or on a river and tell that person what to do? In the pre-management of expectations, a good guide would ask the client, what do you want out of your day? And if that conversation takes place, I encourage the guide to let the client to let the guide steer the day. You're not going to know if he's a crappy guide if you keep making him do everything that you want and then the fishing doesn't turn out. So my point of that is like you going in there and influencing the day is just going to make things worse. And some of the best clients are people that we just work together. We're a team. And it's not like telling me how to take them down the river, where to take them. It's like,
This is what we get to do every single day for most of us, and this is why we're guides. So I would say the number one thing that a good client does is just kind of like take the leadership of their guide. And I could go on for a little longer, but my time is out. Just like Facebook comments. Oh, that's so sad. Everybody's Facebook. What's even worse is my music tonight. How am I ending the show on this, Tim?
Well, it's I know you think it's different than normal, but it, oh, there he goes.
There's
gotta
go.
Get that. Gotta get it up. You know.
Gotta. Yeah, that's what she said.
Did she? Much better. Yeah, that's what we've been waiting for.
Who's there? Okay, so looks like, folks, I'm looking at Facebook here. But I highly encourage the Facebook people to go to YouTube, because Facebook, your comments aren't showing up. And that's a bigger problem with Facebook, is because they are trying to, I'm still ranting in this scene. I got to switch, because folks, for the first time ever, we have somebody new on the couch. Might as well go say hi to them.
Might as
Where
well.
Are they? I can't find them.
Oh, there they are.
Ninjas.
The chess. Who is that? Put a camera on a man and make him humble. Steven, introduce yourself.
Hello, all. I'm Steve Lyle.
Triple Point Chemical.
The man, the myth, the legend. The real Jen Lyle, folks. He's finally
that
on
the couch. That is the real Jen Lyle. That is the 0.5 guy who is reviewing the 0.5 beers tonight.
They are very good.
And the beer I just tried,
Saska Berry 0.5.
How was it?
Very, very good.
Nice.
Highly recommended.
Yeah. So, question for you guys on the couch before we get into the giveaways.
Answer for you guy in the toque.
Answer?
Tukes. You said question for you guys. I said answer for you guys.
All right. What does a good client do? Seeing as you guys have both been in our boats.
For me personally, set expectations for the day. Like, what do you want to learn? You know, and the awesome thing about guides is they're so full of knowledge, they can pick away at, you know, like, hey, I want to learn the double haul today. Okay, you know, like, let's do that. Or, you know,
you
like,
can't double haul.
You can ask to learn. You can ask to learn.
Yeah, you can ask to learn. Yeah,
but, you know, like, I think set expectations right out of the gate for the day so you have an understanding. Also, number one thing, listen to your guide. Listen. Yeah. I think it's a super important thing.
Doesn't seem that difficult.
But you know, like, some people get frustrated, right?
Yeah.
So they get frustrated.
Some people even leave the boat.
Yeah.
And try to walk home.
I never left the boat when I paid.
Oh, he's taking advantage of the free fun times.
Oh, yeah. I'll walk out on you boys every time I get a ride.
Chaz is a good client to guide, said Mr. Augustin.
Well, I tell you, me and Eric, we had a glorious day, and he is a phenomenal guide. Love you, Eric.
Jen Lyle, the real. What's something a good client does?
Well, you definitely get out of the truck and try and help put the oars in. That's the first thing you do.
All right, we're going to head to commercial here.
No, I think, I mean, to me, power is, you know, knowledge, and knowledge is power. And if you have paid money, you're usually, if you're doing it your way, you're not gaining new knowledge. And these people are experts, and you've paid them, like Dana said, and if you're not willing to take advantage to get that knowledge, it's your money that you're paying for some of that expertise. So take advantage of that side is one of my first things I'd say. To execute as an angler, not that I do all the time, but if you're open-minded to the suggestions, you'll get better, you'll catch more fish. If you treat it kind of like, I use too many hockey analogies just because
that's what we're used to. Yeah.
And that's what I've done too much of probably. But you're the guy rowing the boat, he's your centerman, and you got two wingers. If you don't let the centerman kind of control the play a little bit, you're going to be offside all the time. That's the way I look at it the most. So let them captain the boat and guide where that boat's going so that you can be decided. You can't look on both sides of that boat when you're fishing it. You got to trust the guy. whether it's a paid guided trip that day or if you're just going down the river with your buddies.
Yeah.
The guy in the middle runs the boat and you'll have way more success. That's the way I look at it.
That's a good point.
And I would have left, but Uber wasn't picking up. I couldn't get an Uber at the next walking bridge.
Yeah. Good times.
We've had some great times.
Yes, that I can attest to.
Yeah.
Even and loud music.
Is Tree Roy still here?
Yeah, he's upstairs.
Yep. All right.
Turn the music down.
I thought, so on Facebook, there's a lady here. Her name is Carolyn Mary. And she said, when your guide says come to the middle of the boat, you get to the middle of the boat.
Hey, man. Okay. You know somebody's follower.
This is my point. So one time we were going down, the water was really shallow and dirty. It had just, you know, for the second year in a row, absolutely blown out on Chaz and Carolyn, which turned out to be in our favor. And it was really skinny. And Carolyn's in the front and she's looking back at me and she's like, do you see the rock here? I do see the rock and I'm trying to mitigate this. So this is another point. If you're in the back of the boat, we got stickers for this. If you're in the front of the boat, don't lean. Nobody likes a Captain Morgan's. And how does a Captain Morgan's look, Tim? Well, 1 foot up on the side of the boat and you're leaning to the side. Okay. So the guy in the back of my boat is fully, you can see him right here. Somebody made a comment that said, I'm headed to the Smokies this weekend and I'm pretty sure the bear's there. They're much smaller than the two Bruins on the couch. Okay, so we've understood the size out to which I'm dealing with. And Chaz is just hanging out on the side of the boat and we're bumping and we're in trouble. And I just tap him and say, hey, Chaz, come to the middle of the boat. The next thing I know, I'm trying to mitigate this drift boat. And Chaz literally walks to the middle of the boat.
Leg and, over your shoulder.
And sits
over
on my
your
lap.
Left shoulder.
And I'm just staring at him. I'm like, what are you doing? He said, sir, you said come to the middle of the boat. Right
like
then,
nuts?
I knew I had a keeper.
Yep. That's a real client right there.
Yeah.
He listens.
Factual. He's like, you said come to the middle of the boat. And we still laugh about that quite often.
It was a great day, though.
It was a great day.
And we missed the rock.
Yeah. We
miracles happened.
Yes, it did. And I'm getting rid of that boat shortly. All right. So I'm trying to check Facebook people, if you're here and you want to go over to YouTube, that would be great too, because we're about to give away 32 different prizes. Everybody's put in here, and I'm just double checking one more time because we're going to go say thanks to our sponsors. We're going to come back and we're going to pull the draws. Tim's going to write it down. Everything, we think we've got it kind of a bit more fluid right now. So what happens is we have an app called Pixter. And when you purchase your donations, when you donate, we put those donations into here and then we just hit pick. And it randomly picks. And actually, we're so kind that when you win, you get thrown back in. So people have won multiple times before. So don't give up. Don't quit. One more time. Okay, I'm checking here when the commercials come back. If you buy something after the commercials, I don't have the ability to put it in. So we appreciate that donation. And
that pure donation.
Commercials back. Here we go, folks.
Let's do it.
Dude, we're done tired. Like, this is
I know.
I'm avoiding this feeling.
Tim, you killed it this season.
This is what we do.
Thanks, buddy.
That's what we do with the Polaroids.
Oh, it focused. It
did a bit. We tapped Chaz's tip 7G5.
75R.
Commercials. Let's go.
In the heart of nature, when hunger strikes and time is of the essence, Morning View Mercantile has the solution. Witness how we redefine convenience. It's not just a meal, it's an experience. In mere moments, a feast emerges. Delight in the flavors of the wilderness. Morning View Mercantile, your partner in adventure, your ally in taste. For every adventure, a memorable meal. Morning View Mercantile, where every bite is an expedition.
Being up in the high Rockies or up in that area, the different species, right? Still looking to get a brookie under the belt, still looking to get a bull under the belt, but you know, the fish are amazing, and just the landscape is second to none.
All right, folks, who is ready? Oh, some new couch folks.
Okay. Sean Ellison. Sean Ellison, guys, just dropped one here.
Oh, he's so good at doing
it. He's a sneakmeister. We're going to add his tickets in here. We're going to add his 412 tickets.
Where are we at for the countdown on my tickets?
Apparently he just...
On your tickets?
No, just tickets in general.
Oh.
When's the cutoff?
Right now.
Oh, right now.
Right now.
It's over. It's over.
Too bad, so sad, everybody.
Too bad, so sad. What's up, Craft Beer Nation? Back
what's
on the couch
what's
again.
Up?
Hello.
2 weeks in a row.
Hey.
It doesn't get better than that.
Yeah. Time flies, man.
I know. It doesn't seem like a week ago you're here.
It was crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nuts.
What's also crazy is just watch this.
Perfect. Much better.
Look at that. I was checking in on the couch folk.
Yeah.
Over there.
Viewership just went up with all that stuff. Over there, man.
Gotta check, boys. That's you guys sleeping. Are done.
Stream might be crashing here any moment.
Look at that. Everybody's there and they're waiting. They've got their tickets. They've got their donations ready. Sandy Gamash says, I can't comment on YouTube. Well, okay, guys, I'm also monitoring Facebook here, but the party seems to be on YouTube.
Seems to be YouTube.
The party's actually here tonight.
Tom transitioned to YouTube.
Okay, guys, just hang on. We just got another one from John Mill Holland.
Oh, man, the last minute ones are coming in. They're really, you had the
you
whole show,
the
guys. You had the whole show, and now you're doing it.
We're going to need 3 hours to add these tickets.
Yeah, that's okay. We have nowhere to go, and we have no other episodes for the rest of the year. John.
Are we filling time? Is that what's going on?
Yeah.
We can talk about
beers. What are you drinking?
What do I got here? I brought a 88 small batch, Streets of Fire. It's a hazy IPA.
Hey, is that hazy?
Yeah. It's pretty hazy.
It sounds hazy.
Look at him. He's a pro.
He knows what's up.
Except I got to figure this out.
There you go.
See, the difference is these are cheap cameras, and that's a very expensive cinema camera, and the tap method apparently doesn't work.
Yeah, that's better. You just got to be further away. You worked.
It likes you in focus.
Yeah, just not your peer.
I look better out of focus, let's be honest here.
Well, the camera didn't think so.
But she's hazy. A little bitter for me, I think, actually. Typically, that's not something I pick up on, but when I was drinking this one, I was like, what is it? Something
too much
for me
hazy.
Is a little off. It could be the third or fourth haze, possibly.
Yeah. Oh, so two haze.
Yeah.
Two haze is good.
Let's not get crazy with the hazy.
Yeah.
Too much haze.
And Tiff, she's got her signature here. Tried.
Did you get the Jeff Palmer again?
I can't believe I didn't bring
somehow
that.
Those got sold out immediately last
right?
week.
All of a sudden, crazy.
High demand.
I did a thing.
Oh my god.
I have a mango peeler from Darkwoods.
No.
I feel like I did that last time too.
I think you did. It's again, still loves your guys' faces better than the beer cans. That's okay.
Totally fine.
All right, so we have a bit
you
of
can be confident that's always in stock because it's by demand by TIFF that you can't sell out of that.
So. It's dangerous.
It is so good, I'll admit. That's
so guys, I'm trying to tell you about a bit of a situation.
Okay, tell us.
Okay, so a friend of mine named Dave, he said, hey, that gift card that you have here, we're going to throw $150 on it. And got a new
we
one?
We got a sleeve. No, just
a sleeve.
Well,
just,
we don't,
just the sleeve to put it in.
We don't have the insert.
Oh, my God.
Because it went in the package to Mike, and I messaged Mike. I feel like this is like a rom-com. I was like, Mike, the gift card. He's like, oh, no, I already spent it when I was there. I just threw it out. So how do we do this?
Oh, that one. So
can
after
you
took
cancel
a picture
it?
Of it and then sent it to me.
And then you reloaded it, but it was already on its way to Mike.
Oh, so then he got the card.
He had it. But he
Mike,
threw
those
it
are
out.
Reusable cards, man. Don't throw those out. We can reload
it.
Those.
He threw it out because he didn't think it was any good anymore.
You know what? I have a photo of that number.
Yes.
We'll write it on this sleeve.
Okay.
Bring it in. I can look it up.
Okay.
And
there we'll
go.
Still
there
spend
we go.
It.
That's better.
Yeah.
We'll pretend the card's there when it's
or go to the local dump that's by Mike's house. Start scratching.
See,
I think it was, what, 108001 maybe?
It's a rom-com. It's like
we'll,
my
we'll
favorite shows.
We'll
do you guys know that I'm severely addicted to what are
rom-coms?
They called? Rom-coms.
Yeah, we both are.
Watched
we,
one with
we
you
watched
today.
It was great.
Yeah, sorry, that is my weakness.
His dirty secret.
Well, there's Mr. Dumont right there.
So yeah, it's good to
romantic
know.
Comedy.
So he's in the dump right now.
Yeah, he's going through the trash. Where's that card at?
All right, I just don't want to miss anyone, so I just. Double checking. The cutoff is
right meow.
Now.
Is it time?
I'm just reloading. Yep, John was the last. Okay, here we go, all folks. Right. We've got 32 prizes, 32 packages, 32 gifts that if you don't like what was put together.
You can blame me.
I was going to say it, but then I was like, I would never throw my best friend under the bus. When's the first float of 2024? Well, for some of the guys, it was a couple weeks ago. Travis, Dr. Pepper, Dana. That's true. It's American Dr. Pepper, which I'm going to stock up on when I go down to Montana this week. If anybody's on the Missouri next week, say Wednesday, Thursday, why don't you stop in at Wolf Creek? Me and the Jen Lyle. I shouldn't say that. It sounds like I'm taking Steve's wife fishing. I have.
I thought you were.
But Steve, the real Steve Lyle. We're heading down. We're going to go down to Idaho Falls, pick up a boat. We're going to work our way up through Jackson Hole. We're going to go through Yellowstone National Park. We're going to go spend the night in Bozeman. We're going to head our way up and finish the week in Wolf Creek with Wolf Creek Anglers. And what did Wolf Creek Anglers donate to the giveaways tonight?
Yeah, there is two nights stay at their cabins, as well as a full guided day on the Missouri River. They donated for the final.
That's incredible.
It's a good $1,500 value right there.
All right. This is what we're doing. This is say,
do
some
it.
Of the prizes. Oh, I just hope everything goes well.
Deep breath. It's going to be awesome.
You guys think this is really the winning disco music, or do we got to go? What do we got to do? What kind of music do we need to find on this?
Something better than this.
We did last year. What was it called? It was called.
Do you have any Jamaican K-pop? J-pop?
J-pop?
Oh, JK pop. Just kidding. Just kidding.
Just kidding.
It was called like.
You're looking at me like I would remember this.
Yeah, you don't even remember that I narrated your whole fly for you and pretty much made tonight no work for you.
Touché.
No,
No, this wasn't it. Okay, what was it? I have it right here. Polka, that's what it's called. Polka seems to be a good mix of music for this. That's good.
That's good. There you go.
Yeah, can you guys all hear the music in the background? Oh, that's what makes you beautiful. All right.
You're just looking for excuses.
Giveaways, take them off the screen. Now let's put this one on the screen. And that's kind of how it goes. So, if everything goes to plan, things should start popping up there, like winners, right? Yeah. So, Facebook people, I am so sorry. ZZ Top's in the house. Now it's a party. We got some polka. Are you going to pull your boat through Yellowstone and snow machines? With snow machines. We don't know what we're doing, okay? Sounds like a bad idea, Dan. Thanks for telling me now. All right. Okay, first of all, the prize is at top there. And I said I was going to do something like the screenshot, so keep me accountable to that, Tim.
Yes. So it's pretty simple, guys. As a winner, if you hear your name come up, you can see the instructions there. You got to email right there, your prize number, your address, your phone number, and your name. We also are recording your name, so if we don't hear from you, we will make effort to contact you. But yes, you don't have to be watching right now to win, but yeah, reach out.
Okay, well, we're going to see how the first one works. We tried it beforehand and it seemed to work because your name will pop up there and it's a total random system here. It's the app called Pixter. You can go try it out for yourself just to make sure you love it or not, or whatever. And so the first prize is a Fly Fishing Bow River sun shirt, a Fly Fishing Bow River hat, a dry fly box. So that's full of dry flies.
Yeah.
A box full of dry flies and a Fly Fusion subscription. And like Tim said, and it also says below, you got to email us and say, hey, I was prize number one, my number, my name, my address, all those things so that we can ship that out to you. It makes our life so much easier. All right, for the first winner of the night, we're going to hit pick. That's all I do is hit this button. It says pick. And the winner's Carson Toy.
Oh, Carson.
Carson never wears a hat and he burns.
Yeah, he never wears a hat.
Burns quite often. All right,
seriously,
so
red at the
end. Screen capture. Number one, photo saved so that we know what you won, what you didn't win. All right, folks, there's 31 more to go. Don't get discouraged. We've got lots more. All right, Facebook.
All right, number two.
I'm watching you down here. All right, so number one's off the screen, and I'm going to go over here. I feel like there's a lot of pressure on me.
A few buttons to press.
Do all the buttons right. All right. A triple point chemical. Thanks to Steve Lyle, who you saw on the couch earlier. So a triple point chemical sun shirt. So it's a collab with Fly Fishing Bow River Outfitters, and there are going to be quite a few of those here today. A Fly Fishing Bow River hat. A tacky spelt wrong fly box full of streamers.
Touchy.
And a Fly Fusion subscription. And approximately $300. Should have been $300, but it just says $300. So, we're off to a bad start. But you can imagine what it would be like if we were perfect. Or can you?
Oh, can you?
I don't know. Anyways, the winner of number two is quite simply here. I'm just going to hit the button that says pick. And Scooter Tabor. Round of clicks for Tabor, Toy and Tabor. Screenshot. Thanks for reminding me, Tim.
I got you.
You didn't. I'm going to have to go back and watch the show and manually screenshot. All right, all right, all right. That's number two. We still got 30 more to go.
All right, guys. Number three is drum roll.
Donated by Rick Flink.
Yeah, this is that Sage SLT-590-4 fly rod blank. And all custom components.
Yeah, so what I want to tell you about these custom components components is he said it includes a complete guide set with a stripper ring, so maybe strippers and they're going to show up. The appropriate size tip top, a hook keeper, a German silver winding check, strobel reel seat, and a custom made wood insert that Rick made specifically for this rod. Finally, it comes with a half-well's grip made out of a double A cork rings that Rick personally turned on the lathe himself. It's a nice setup for sure, and this value is around $450 American built in the factory. If he were to build it for you, so maybe if you don't build rods, you're like, hey, Rick, maybe build it for me, right?
Yeah.
So you've won all the components. Maybe just got to slap him down a little bit of money for his time. But we thank Mr. Flink, who works so hard in the fly fishing industry, to just make it a better place. And this one here is number 3. Okay, all these prices are Canadian, so if you're confused, our dollar sucks.
All right, let's see the winner.
Oh, Scott. From Detroit, Michigan, Scotty Borschelt and Tiff's dying.
I got a good joke for you with that rod. How do you change a fly fishing rod into a fishing pole? You put a stripper ring on it.
And who thought fly fishing was so fun? Round of clicks, Mr. Scott Borschelt, you are the winner. Reach out to us again. I'll put you in contact with Rick. So Rick did not ship that up to us because I said, hey, if an American wins it, which Scott is, you guys can deal. So that's pretty epic. There, he loves it right there. Yep.
Awesome.
This is good. This is going good so
that's
far.
Good.
Okay.
Real good.
I didn't screenshot, but thanks for reminding me, Tim.
Screenshot.
Okay.
If
you didn't remind me, I remind myself. All right, 29 more to go, folks. This one here, in case you're just tuning in, this is part of our $18,300 Lucky Fly Box donation. Remember when we did was give away a box full of flies?
A single fly box, yeah.
Yeah.
It's come a little ways.
So this one here is a Season 6 Thursday Night Live fly tying kit, a fly fishing bow over hat, a tacky fly holder, a fish pond sandbar travel pouch valued at approximately $400.
Pretty good kit.
And the winner of number 4 is Victor Edmond. Winner, winner. Screenshot. All right, round of clicks for Victor Edmond. Round of clicks. All right, have a drink. Wet your whistle.
I'm out of drinks.
See some tequila behind you there, Tim.
Oh, here we already did that.
We already did our finale.
You guys were nowhere to be found.
She's looking pretty thin.
All right, Victor, congratulations on number 4. This one is an either or. Okay, we have a couple either ors in here because we know some people can't quite get here for exactly this. So you just got to let us know what you want either or, right? Here it goes. Number 5 is a guide school client float. So you get a full day of fly fishing on May 6th with us. So if you can't make that work, then you're going to win a fly fishing bow over hat, a t-shirt, a sun shirt, and a sticker pack. You don't win both. You just win. You got to do an either or, right? So when you win, let us know. Either or. Right?
All right.
You've been writing this
I'm
down?
I'm writing, yep. Kay. Number 5. Let's go.
Picking it. Terry Ferguson. Well, that guy is a local.
Yes,
a local Yoko. That's Kenny's buddy, Mr. Terry Ferguson. Screenshot. Save.
Screenshot it, Dan.
He's probably not watching because he's busy doing other things in life. But Terry, congratulations. You let us know. He's probably going to go for the day of fishing.
I put money on that one.
All right. That's number 5.
On to number 6.
It's getting hot.
This is a good one, guys. So
this
is
one's great.
What you want. It's an Orvis. You didn't even pull it up yet. An Orvis Clearwater fly rod. So you get to place your choice in what size, so what weight of rod you want. You're going to get an Orvis Hydros reel to match the rod and an Orvis Hydros line to also match that same. So you get rod, reel, and line of your choice in weight.
Yeah, and the value is approximately $900 Canadian. So you just got to let us know in your email, hi, I would like a 6-weight. And then we'll do that. We'll make it a 6-weight for you. You want a 4-weight? You want a 5-weight? Do you want an 8-weight? Just let us know, and we'll take care of that. We'll make sure you get exactly what you want. Because the winner of number 6 is
Victor Edmond. Oh, my gosh.
He won the waiters last year.
He did, yeah.
Yeah.
He's got two now. Season 6 kit.
Screenshot.
Screenshot.
Round of clicks for Victor Edmund.
Number 2.
Well done, Victor. See, I told you you could win twice.
It's so close.
And Adrian did it a few years ago. Oh, yeah. Wow, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And that was donated by your friends at Fly Fishing Boat Outfitters / Dana and Tim. All right, this next one's pretty cool, too, for all of you. Number 7.
Ooh, some tie-in stuff.
We got to thank Bad Joke Doug for this.
We do. He donated.
Yep.
You got your Norvice bobbin kit. So that comes with a bobbin and a couple of spools. I think 3, in fact. And then he also has given a Norvice spool kit, which is another 10 spools on top of that. You're also going to get a Norvice custom tying table, so to affix your Norvice to. And you're also getting a Fly Fusion subscription valued at $450.
Wow. Thanks to our sponsors and friends of the show /
Bad Joke
Bad Doug. And I almost didn't pick a winner. Okay. The next winner is Scooter Tabor. You can win twice, folks.
Screenshot.
Gotcha. Thank you. All right, Scooter.
Scooter Tabes. Look at this.
Right. We got
two doubles. I got her.
Oh, man. Truth be told, I remember one year somebody bought one ticket. I think they won 3 times.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Playing the odds.
Yeah. Where were we? Number 8?
Yeah, we're on to number 8.
Oh, this one's good.
Oh, this is a good one.
This is really good. All right. This is a Fish Pond Dakota carry-on rod and reel case, which is epic. Kind of want it myself.
Yes.
An Orvis nymph box and a tacky fly caddy.
Yeah, that's a great kit there. Valued around $350 worth of merchandise. Thank you to Fish Pond, our sponsor, for donating.
And
they got some
and
more coming.
Troy Langelaar.
And Troy Langelaar, yep.
Yeah, all the tacky products have been donated from formerly West River Fly Shop / Troy Langelaar. All right, here we go. This one you want. So cross your fingers and say, this is the one I want. I'm just going to hit the button pick.
Let's go.
Justin Fisher.
He's in the house, too.
He's in the house.
Literally in the house.
All right. Saved on shipping.
That's one you really wanted to not have to ship to.
Yeah, that's a big prize.
Big carry-on.
Screenshot.
Screenshot, guaranteed. I got you. Screenshot.
Screenshots are good if you screenshot all of them, but I miss them.
I don't
Congratulations,
so.
Justin
Congratulations,
Fisher.
Justin.
That's worth its weight in gold. All right. Number 8. So number nine is a local product.
Yep.
But it's given by our sponsor, Lyle Peterman Real Estate. And Lyle Peterman is also the voice of the American Hockey League's Calgary Wranglers.
Yes.
So he has donated a Calgary Wranglers American Hockey League game experience for 2. Also, you're going to get 2 Triple Point Chemical sun shirts.
Yes.
And that is donated by Lyle Peterman Real Estate because he's also the voice of the Calgary Wranglers.
Yes, he is.
Let's see who wins this one. Put your fingers together in that kind of fashion, and that gives you better luck. Douglas Robson. That's fantastic. He can actually do that. Doug and Elaine are off to the Wranglers for the game experience.
Is that Bad Joke Doug?
That's
bad. Is his last name? I never
knew
that.
It was screenshot.
Screenshot.
Almost forgot. All right, Doug, congratulations on that. And thank you for your donation of the Norway's Bobbins. Setup, things, spools, all the good stuff. All right, Doug, congratulations. You're the winner of number 9, Lyle Peterman Real Estate, the Calgary Wranglers game day experience. All right. The next prize, I can't quite see all of it, but I'm sure it's good because it starts with FFBR sun shirt.
There's a lot in this one, guys. A lot of things. So we've got an FFBR sun shirt, an FFBR LPCF t-shirt, You're also getting an FFBR hat and an FFBR sticker package. You're also getting a tacky dry fly box and a fly fusion subscription.
Wow.
That is a lot of things in there.
So essentially what you can do is you can sit on the edge of the river, read your fly fusion subscription, which will probably have some good tips and tricks on how to use all those dry flies that are in there. At the same time, get your wife or husband or friend or whatever to take a picture of you while wearing the swag. And my friends, that is an Instagram post. So we'll call this winnings on Instagram post. And the winner of number 10, the Instagram post, is Robert McQuaid. Congratulations, Robert. You are the winner of this stuff.
Congratulations. Stuff up here.
Screenshot.
Screenshot.
All right. Almost forgot that one. All right. Wow. It's 9:07. We're so ahead of schedule. We don't have a schedule. We don't even have another episode.
Oh, we're moving on to number 11 here, guys.
Number 11.
I know. I was like,
I didn't think anyone was sitting there, and I was like, do they see ghosts? All right, this is another either or, so let us know. Either or. Do you want either or? Just like it was before. This is what it looks like. All right, so it's a glide school. You come into glide school, you can learn how to glide. Guide school client float trip on May 6th, or you have a choice to take the Fly Fishing Bow River sun shirt, the Fly Fishing Bow River t-shirt, the Fly Fishing Bow River hat, and the sticker pack. Either or, let us know if you win. When you win, let us know, folks. So we're getting ready to pick a winner. We just hit the pick button.
Hit the button.
This wig's getting really hot. And the winner's Corey Mahan. So maybe he comes and does the trip.
Yeah, I think that's a great
idea. We don't know. I think that would be really full circle, seeing as he was one of the students at the very first guide school.
He was.
All right, Corey, screenshot.
Screenshot.
Corey, let us know what you want to do, and we'll go from there. You know what I'm saying?
No, I'm saying.
All right, number 11.
No regrets.
All right, up next is a great prize. Yeah, this all great, this is fantastic. But like, yeah.
You've ever wanted to get into a little trout spay action? Well, Rocky Mountain Fly Shop has donated their Reddington Field Kit Trout Spay. It is a 11'3" weight. Also comes with a line, a reel, and you're also getting a tacky fly box and a reel hat in there as well.
Yeah.
Full meal deal, $800 value.
Rocky Mountain Fly Shop coming through with the big prizes. And that's pretty epic trout spay. And, I mean, might as well get a kit if you're just getting into it. All right, let's see who the winner of prize number 12 is. Gonna hit the pick button. Juanita. Oh, back-to-back Mahans.
The Mahans.
Back-to-back. Maybe they're gonna bring this and come on the trip and trout spay out of a boat.
Oh, man, please.
While wearing a real hat. And bring their tacky fly box. Or maybe they're just gonna get the hat and the shirt and the t-shirt and then go home and trout spay. Screenshot. Almost missed that one.
He did. That was
Congrats.
Congrats Juanita. To the Mahans.
Yeah. All right. You know how you win, folks. You just got to donate. And, well, that's past. That's in the past. All right. We're at number 12. We're going on to number 13. And this one, Tim will tell you what it is.
Yeah. So, number 13, you've got a season 6 kit. So you're getting your T-Mill Season 6 kit, an FFBR hat. You're getting a tacky biflox. A tacky fly box with flies, an FFBR LPCF t-shirt.
So talk about those fly boxes, because you loaded them up with flies.
Man. Mildly tedious packing
that,
all these flies.
You said you like to do
I
that.
Do like it, but like the 50th fly box got old.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of... yeah, so all the fly box, not all fly box you're going to see come up have flies in them, but the ones that say with flies, most of them are an assortment of dries and nymphs and streamers. Lots of those in here.
Yeah. All right, here we go. We're going to pick the winner for prize number 13, and the winner is Mike Ritzko.
Mike.
There he goes. I think every year he wins a season kit. I think he won one at IF4 last year.
Yeah.
Oh, I almost forgot a screenshot.
Screenshot.
All right, Mr. Ritzko. Congratulations. Fly fishing boat over. Love people catch fish. T-shirt, which Tim's wearing. They come in a few different colors. You got to let us know what you have, what your size is, and we'll get you fitted. All right, so that's it for number 13. And boom. The next fly here, folks, is dubbed the Fly Tires Orgasm.
It's a full kit.
It's full gamut.
Yeah, you
can
see
it all
there.
If this doesn't do it for you, nothing will.
Well, okay, so there's lots of stuff in here. You got bobbins, you got tools, forceps, you got UV, you got so much.
You got a loon
shore,
UV light.
Shore tying supplies.
The word is plethora.
Plethora. So all you can say is there's a ton of materials in here, a lot of tools for tying. You're also getting thrown the fish pond travel pouch, as well as triple point chemical sun shirt, an Orvis nymph box, and a Fly Fusion subscription. So that is a very full kit.
Yeah.
Awesome.
That is full. And the winner of prize number 14 is quite simply here. Pick Catherine Lazaruk.
Screenshot.
That's a good point. Screenshot. Congrats, Catherine, on that. Just send us an email below. Let us know all of those details. And you've just got yourself a Fly Tires Orgasm. I mean, it's true.
Lucky girl.
All right. All right. Congratulations. All right. So the next one is one I hopefully win.
Yeah, this is a good one.
This is a good one. All right. This one's big. It's not even halfway.
I know. Not quite.
A fish pond Teton, which is hopefully where me and Steve go, but according to Dan, you got to snow plow the snow out. Maybe I'm stupid, but the fish pond Teton rolling carry on luggage.
Yeah, that's pretty epic.
Did you see it out there? Yeah.
I know, I did. I packed it away.
A tacky fly box loaded with flies, a triple point chemical sun shirt, and a tacky fly caddy.
That's a great kit. Ready to travel.
So I was just going to say, that's like, hey, I'm going to Montana. I should win it.
If your name shows up on there.
Where are you going?
A little further south.
Is your candle not burnt anything down yet?
Not yet.
You happy I brought it back for you? Because I heard you complaining earlier.
Yeah, it's nice. Very nice scent in here.
It's not burning any cats. What is burning is my sweat and heat. It's hot in here.
It's so hot in here.
Okay. Number 15, the big prize here. The winner is, just going to hit pick, Joey Harshaw. Joey, you've won. In case you didn't know, that's how you win. Your name pops up. And screenshot.
Congratulations, Joey. That is a great...
Yeah, Joey, send us an email. Let us know how we can get this good stuff to you. And if you don't want it, also write that in the email, and I'll take it.
Somehow, I think that's a doubtful one.
Yeah. Joel Sather, that would be handy. That guy travels.
He gets around, yeah.
Yeah. All right.
All right, on to 16.
I'm just like ramping up the music here. we're like halfway. That's only halfway. Joey, congrats. I screenshotted that, right?
You did.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for remembering.
You're welcome.
All right, number 16 from our friends over at Trax Pub. It's a $50 giveaway / gift card. Two Trax Pub sweatshirts, a Trax, I changed it from toque to winter hat because a lot of our American friends don't know what a toque is.
Toque.
So I had to say winter hat, an Orvis fly box, which those fly boxes are some of my favorite fly boxes.
Yep, great name.
And a Triple White Chemical sun shirt and a Fly Fusion subscription.
Great little gift pack.
That's a 1-year subscription, folks.
1 year.
That's a gooder. All right. The winner of number 16 is Cam Smith. Cam Smith, you're the winner. Screenshot. All right. And that's how it goes. We just keep pulling names and winners keep winning.
That's how it works.
We got our rolls. Tim's writing them down. And, I'm struggling to get through this lazy bear. Is that anyone else having that problem? I'm the only one drinking it. Nobody else seems to care that I'm struggling. Oh, you guys?
Slowly.
You're not muted.
It. No, I don't know why Dave's not talking. I'm not the beer person.
Did Dave pass out?
Dave's snoozing, sleeping.
I'm just. He's so trying not to pass out from the heat.
Well, open the door. Yeah. You can open the door.
Dave, crack the door.
Crack the door. Let the flow. Let the ornicono flow in. All right,
I'm more
Cam.
Curious what Tim was like on that hurry.
What do you think of it?
It's different. It's a white chocolate stout. So
yeah,
it's definitely.
Try it. It's
a different taste. I enjoyed it. I just drank it. When was that?
I feel like
this
it's not
weekend.
A, it's
and
not
I started.
A fast one.
I started my night with that. That's why I was like, careful. That's 10. That's 10%. I might have took a couple midday naps.
Not bad.
Yeah.
That was last Saturday.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
Is it better than the Lazy Bear?
Yeah.
Yep.
The Lazy Bear is not bad. It's just like, it's not leaving the like the back here. It's just not leaving that part of my palate.
Because it's lazy.
That's right. Go home, bear. Okay, this one's really good. This one's so good that I think everyone in here should try to win it. How do you try to win it? Well,
this is a good one.
Number 17.
Morning View Mercantile Goods coming in a fish pond dry bag. And it is absolutely packed full of everything. Yeah, so this would be a fantastic one to win. It's got a variety of all of their freeze-dried goods in that bag. You're also going to be coming away with a fish pond hat, triple point chemical sun shirt, and a fly box full of flies.
Wow.
That's a winner, that one. I like that one.
All right, so how we pick a winner is we just put my name up on the screen.
Yeah.
By
type
pressing Dane. I should just do that, like, raw.
Yeah.
Somebody will complain. And the winner is Terry Sather.
Ah, Terry.
That's a local Yoko. Who, once he gets addicted to that freeze-dried good, folks, he's not going to stop making that path from Sylvan Lake, Craft Beer Nation, Morning View Mercantile, and back. And he'll be back the next week. That's how he kind of rolls. So congrats. Screenshot. Terry Sather and the prize number 17. Well done. All right. So what's up next, you ask? Well, this that we've officially, we have a sleeve for it. So we forgot to, we forgot to mention that it's a $150 sleeve.
Gift card sleeve.
There it is. $150 to Craft Beer Nation.
That price is having a rough go because I brought one of those sleeves to IF4 and lost it in the theater.
Yeah,
it, did you?
It just, so I just brought another one and now we don't have the card
yeah,
to go in.
It just wasn't meant to be. Well, it is meant to be. And it is going to happen. So you're going to get a $150 Craft Beer Nation gift card. You're going to get a fly fishing bow over sun shirt. You're going to get a fly box. You're going to fly fishing bow over hat. You're going to get a fly fishing bow over sticker pack, which you guys didn't even know these exist. And they're not on the website because I screwed up.
Some good ones. I'll show you
because your camera works.
A couple of the new ones.
Oh, look at that one. Love people catch fish. And another new one here. Love people catch fish. That's great. So anyways, we've made up a sticker pack for you guys that's going to be in this giveaway. And oh, that is.
Come here, Ren.
That is priceless. What's happening behind the scenes here?
Who's this? That looks a good look on
we,
you.
We left the tickle trunk open out there, and it looks like
Ted Drester, I think.
You know, Tim Nisfail Jr. has got in. Look at that. She looks like those lawn ornaments, like
a creepy gnome.
A gnome, yeah. All right, we just got to hit the pick button, and then the winner pops up, and the winner is Tamara
Dickow. Nice and local, too.
So that's going to go to good use. Guaranteed screenshot. That is saved. Nice sticker packs. I had that card. I need a sticker pack. Well, folks, you just got to come hang out at the TNL studio. And you probably go home with stickers. Or it's you true. Just got to win like Tamara did.
Congrats, Tamara. Okay, number 18. Oh, man, so many good ones left. Like this one coming up next.
This next one's really good, guys.
Oh, put your fingers together.
If you thought the last one was good, this one's valued even higher because there's more going into it.
Yeah, there's more going into it.
We have another of your choice in weight of fly rod. You're going to get the Orvis Clearwater fly rod with a Hydros fly reel to match it. You're also getting that Hydros fly line to match the rod. You're getting a triple point chemical sun shirt tossed in there and an Orvis fly box. Buy it at $1,000. That's a big one. Everything you need to get going.
Well, I would also love this one. Donated by Fly Fishing Boat Rail Fitters, Triple Point Chemical, and Fly Fishing Boat Rail Fitters. All right, they got their fingers crossed. Look at them, folks. They are crossed.
They want this so bad.
Each other. Trish has her feet crossed. She's wanting to win. And that's...
Who's going to be? Come on, baby.
Should we cut to commercial or should we just pick this? That's how they do it on the real shows.
I know, it's true.
But I'm not that guy. I'm just going to hit pick. All ready? Here we go. That's a great prize. A Clearwater fly rod. A choice. Your choice. All right, here we go. Pick. Heine Bruner.
Heine Bruner. Oh,
my. How beautiful. How beautiful, Heine.
Sorry, guys.
Oh, round of clicks.
You spelled Dave Rutherford wrong.
I did. I did. I started it with an H. Screenshot. Oh, that's fantastic. Nick Best, you crossed your fingers a little too late.
Just a little bit.
But, folks, there is more better-ish great prizes to equal that. That Heine has filled up his quiver with a brand new fly rod.
Very nice.
But thanks to our friends. Our friend, Stephen Lyle, at Triple Point Chemical. He comes through every year wanting to keep you guys safe and dry. I almost said wet. That would have been weird because, like, the last fly. I'll leave that alone.
Please don't touch it.
I didn't touch it. I just narrated it. What are we on? What are we on? Number 20?
Yeah, this
Number
is a 20. Good
one. This is a good one, and I'm super jealous because I don't have a pair of these, but you might.
I might. They're fantastic.
So Triple Point Chemical. This is also an Instagram post. A Patagonia Swift Current Zip Waders. Your choice in size. Just let us know. Triple Point Chemical Sun Shirt and a Fly Fusion subscription. So you could sit on the shore in your fancy new waders and your Triple Point Chemical Sun Shirt, reading a Fly Fusion subscription while your friend, family, wife, kid, whatever, takes a photo of you and posts it on Instagram. This is an Instagram post.
This is an Instagram post, definitely.
All right, let's see who wins.
Who's the lucky winner?
All right, anybody's fingers crossed. Everybody's fingers crossed.
Dave's even cross-eyed.
I actually really want to win. If you don't recognize the name that pops up, Tim, it's me.
Okay.
George Norton from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. That's not me. I recognize the name. It's not me.
Ah, too bad.
Well, George, congratulations. You just got to let us know what size you are, and these $1,000 Patagonia waders are yours.
Coming your way.
Wow. Could you imagine? I've literally never won anything.
I don't.
It's why I didn't rig the system and put in 4,000 tickets for myself. What? I didn't screenshot. Oh, we almost snuck away with one there.
See, I like how we connect. We look back at each other.
Yeah, we do. We're in sync. That's what makes you beautiful. Close enough. I have a treat for you at the end of the show, Tim.
Oh, man.
You're not going to want to leave early. Okay, folks. Okay, good. All right, folks. You know what's better than one orgasm?
An Easter bunny.
two tires orgasms in one night. And so this is similar to the same plethora of shore materials, shore tools, shore supplied thread, a shore t-shirt, and a fly box full of nymphs, and a fish pond sandbar travel pouch valued around 400 $1,000.
So many good things.
So many prizes left. Look at them all. Still, so many prizes left. Oh, this feels biased based on shipping costs. Well, there's that. I have not been watching the Facebook comments. I feel guilty. So I'm just going to check them and see what's up. And see what's happening here. I've got some Facebook. Where is it? Can't see it. Guys, I really want to be in tune with you guys. But I can't
Facebook
see it.
Facebook has been struggling so much today.
It's literally just... It's Facebook, man. Like, honestly, they just don't want to be friendly anymore. So... Maybe we forever... Oh, I found it. Okay. Michael says, only good fly is a wet fly. You have to get them wet to make them work.
It's true. Unless it's a dry fly.
Are you guys playing Drunken Prize Giveth Away? David Blackman. David, so I'm checking Facebook because the Facebook comments aren't coming into YouTube. So you did join in because David got his tickets. So... Number 21, the tires. Orgasm. And the winner is of this one here. Number 21 is quite simply Travis Booth. That's awesome. That's fantastic. Travis, congrats, my friend. This one's, John, this one is shipping. We're shipping this one. This one isn't a bias based on shipping. It's so says John, who won a fly IKEA table the first year, and the most monstrosity package.
Oh, that was a big one.
That I had to ship to him. Anyways.
Not local.
Screenshot. All right. I think I've missed one, but that's it. Number 21 goes to Travis Booth. Congratulations, sir. We appreciate you. And moving on.
Onward to 22.
Oh, this is a great one, too.
Yeah, so thank you to our sponsors at Fish Pond. They have the Roll Top Backpack, the Wind River Roll Top waterproof backpack. You're also getting a Loon Essentials Kit, which is a forceps and nippers kit. You're getting some Oros indicators, a Tacky Fly Caddy, an Orvis Fly Box, and a Triple Point Chemical Sun Shirt, valued at $500. It's a great backpack. Yeah,
that's a great backpack. Don't have one. Not going to win one.
Nope.
All right. So the winner of number 22, heading over here to the pick button, is just quite simply Trevor McPhee. I believe he's White Court. Somewhere up there. Screenshot. Trevor, congratulations, my friend. That's quite the haul.
That is quite the haul.
We'll call that a haul because you win and you're got a lot of stuff. All right, Trevor, congratulations. The prizes, folks, are just getting more.
More.
And like number 23, the prize package here is quite simply the Orvis Pro Wading Boots. Your size, you just got to let us know. That's from Triple Point Chemical. Fly Fishing Bow River Sun Shirt, the Fly Fishing Bow River Hat, and the Sally Waterflies?
Saltwater Flies, definitely.
Okay, I screwed up again. Saltwater Flies in a fly box, valued around $600. Let us know when you win, what your size is, and we'll get those sent out to you right away in about 20 days. That's right away. All right, so the winner of number 23, the Orvis Pro Wading Boots and such things is... Hit the pick button.
Let's see it.
Aaron Novlan.
A.A. Ron.
And A.A. Ron.
Korean K-pop himself.
Korean K-pop. The guy, the man, the myth, the legend who tied along for two episodes, bought tickets. We let him. Yes, we did. We let him. He's going to take those saltwater flies to Louisiana, probably.
He just might.
You never know. All right, screenshot.
Screenshot it.
Take it or leave it. He's not watching. He's working.
He's working.
But you don't have to watch. Oh, we got a couple bangers coming up here.
Yeah. There are some big bangers.
Oh, I'd be happy with a pack of jerky. John, we can send you a pack of jerky.
Oh, speaking of jerky, there's some good jerky out there.
That's a good point. It's like a lot of people say every year, it's, you know, the winning is fantastic, but they would just be happy with candy. So yeah, we can take their prizes back.
Replace
sub
it
them
with
for candy.
Some peach
it's easy.
Ones.
It's easy to do. Okay, the a screenshot of that?
Yes, you I did.
Think so. Okay. The next one is this.
Number 24, season 6, all tie flies. So this is all the patterns. There's 23 patterns, 6 of each, 156 in the box. These are all the flies that we tied this season, and we put them all in the box. The original fly box giveaway was this.
This was the original. Started. This is all we gave away was this. I put it over here because it used to be here all year.
Yeah, we packed it away.
Yeah, so as Tim gets pre-tying and practicing and ready for the show, this is it. This is all the flies. Like, what an incredible thing. Kind of a memorabilia. If you never fish them, it's something you can just put on your shelf. You know, you average out those flies to like $4 a fly. Average. Easily they're more. But do the math, folks, and that's what you got here. Plus, you get an Orvis Nymph box. And Mr. Troy Langelars donated a tacky fly box and a tacky fly caddy. We're going to value this one around $700.
Amazing.
And who wins? Who do you think wins?
Andy. Yeah, Andy. Hillberry Tax Story.
Andy.
That's
okay.
What I'm going with.
I'm going to pick Gavin Jones.
All right.
No, Mike Pafuti. Mike Pafuti. Screenshot. You are the winner of this marvelous package. And yeah, that's pretty epic. That is
awesome.
Pretty freaking awesome. Congrats, Mike. You're the winner of number 24. Send us an email. We're going to get this out to you ASAP. We were both wrong, by the way, in guessing.
We were.
What if we get it right, though, in guessing? Do people think we're cheating?
I don't know. I think we proved that we're not.
All right, number 25.
It's identical to 24. The
exact same thing.
Exact same
because thing. If you were like, man, I wish I would have won that. See?
Now you get to try again.
We just made all their wildest dreams come true. We gave them hope, Tim. Hope for another day to fight for this, which we call prize number 25.
25.
So we don't have to sell it because we already did that before. And the winner of prize number 25 is... Who do you think is going to win?
Not even going to try.
Mike Plouy. Plouy Bowie.
Plouy Boy?
Yeah.
All right.
Who do you think?
I'm going to go with... Eric.
Just a side note, I forgot to tell everybody about this, but you might have been doing the quizzes every week, and only one person turned it in.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Kay? Every week that you had a quiz, there was a piece of the puzzle that created this photo. Okay, and Mr. McKenna was the only person who colored it and turned it in. And he said, I can't believe the season is over. I took and passed all the quizzes, and I guess I need to turn in my homework. I haven't colored since I was a kid. It was actually kind of therapeutic. Thanks again for making my Thursday evening so cool. So our goal was, and Mike, I've added those to your tickets, but you got five donations added to you because you did the homework, and nobody else turned it in. So sadly enough. Have we not picked a winner?
Not yet.
All right.
See who it is.
We're about to. Ken McCutcheon.
Look at that.
Huh. Fancy that, Kenneth. You've got yourself some tacky fly boxes. A bunch of flies tied by maybe Mr. Hepworth. A screenshot. All right, Ken. Congratulations, brother. He's cheering
he
in the background
heard that
over
he won
there.
Upstairs.
The more people that are here, the win will lead John Onorati to believe that we have a shipping bias. Guys, there's such good big prizes still to come.
Oh, the biggest. It starts right now.
It starts. It's getting real close to becoming something so spectacular. Don't hate me if you get one of the gag gifts coming up. Hey, Tim.
Hey.
All right. This one, number 26, is a simple fly fishing boat or fully guided trip in the year 2024.
The year,
you know what?
24?
If you're from out of town and you can't make it this year, let me know. Justin Fisher will take you next year. All right. Here we go, folks.
Let's see it. This is a good
is a
one.
Great one. Well, we think it's great.
Yeah, I'd hope you want to spend the day with us. All in the river.
All right.
All right, let's see it.
All right. I almost pressed the wrong button, but the right button is here, and it says pick, and I just... And it came. I'm screenshotting that just... Okay, folks, we're redoing this. So, all your...
He was supposed to do the guide the trip for it.
He's taking himself down the river. Ah!
Oh, that was good.
Well, it's random. You obviously see it's random, so don't get upset with us.
Oh, man.
Oh, the laughs I hear from
the
other
rooms. Yeah,
the
laughs from upstairs are almost as good.
Yeah. All right, here we go. The winner.
Again.
New winner for this 26.
Jerome Nova.
Yeah. Cade Bessler. Here it goes.
Here it goes. Let's see it.
Hold your breath. Scott Lorenz.
All right.
Well, Scotty, if you ever make it up from Colorado, I believe, you've got a seat in our boats. Bring your son, bring the young one, and that would be fantastic. So let us know. You're the winner. And I'm going to really screenshot this because Aaron isn't. He's going to be like, bro, I won. Oh, yeah. Jerome's trying to claim it.
Yeah, I knew he would be.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the kind of friends Aaron has.
Old pops.
That's how it goes.
All right, a few more to go.
That's how it goes, folks. So we're going to head back here. We're going to go back into the draws. We're going to pick number 27. This one here is pretty cool because it doesn't even exist.
You're really selling it.
Yet. It's the future. It's more... I think these guys are like...
You'll literally be the very first person to have in your hands...
Yes.
A Season 7 kit. TNL Season 7 kit. You'll be the very first one who ever gets one. Not only that, you're getting a tacky fly box with full of streamers. You're getting an Orvis nymph box, a tacky fly box, a triple point chemical sun shirt, and that is your kit.
Yes, you'll be the first.
Very first.
The Season 7 kit. You don't have to buy it. You just have to receive it. And that is a wonderful... I think it's Dave Rutherford's birthday on Saturday.
Is it?
Yeah, just thought about it.
Dave, if it's your birthday, get down here.
He'll get down here. He'll get down here. He'll get down here. He'll get down here. He'll get down here. Okay, did we give this away
yet?
No,
we haven't yet.
No, we didn't. All right, so...
TNL Season 7
Sorry, guys.
Kit.
Did I screenshot the last one?
Yep.
Oh, here we go. Pick... Matt Millar, you've won Season 7 kit. I don't think you tied with us in Season 6. So, well, you're the first to have Season 7, a tacky fly box full of streamers, an Orvis nympho box. Box? Fox? You don't get fox. We give away fox tails.
Sure.
But not the full fox.
Not the full fox.
What does the fox say? Is it your birthday on Saturday?
It is.
Guys.
It's your birthday. And he's wearing the birthday hat. Oh, man. So let me say happy birthday. You got to come get in the camera. Oh, happy birthday. Oh, and he's going to do the honors.
Oh, he's
going to
finish it off.
The
do
tequila.
It. Finish it off.
There
That's
it goes.
A wrap. That's a wrap. All no right. better way to finish off the season. Did I screenshot this?
I don't know. There it goes. It's
I'm
going
to screenshot it just in case. Matt's going to have some confetti in the screenshot.
Well, Dave.
Happy birthday, buddy.
We love you, buddy. All right, that came in sideways, but thanks for whoever sent that in. Now he's trying to heat us out by shutting the door because he knows it gets hot when the door's shut. All right. If I don't press the button hard enough, you know, we lose the confetti or we lose the song, but sometimes we don't lose both.
Double tap.
All right, Matt, congratulations. Some big things. The next one's real big.
The next one's real big.
You're going to want to win this one. If you haven't won anything tonight, you're going to want to win this one. Where is it? Number 28?
FFBR. Fully guided trip in 2024 with a night stay at Hotel Blackfoot.
Wow, that's the full package.
That's the full package.
So you could come down the night before and stay. You could come down the morning of and fish and stay. Or you could already be down there. And then, or you can fly in from out of town, just get yourself an extra night, and then you get a free night, and all the things are fun, and it's great, and book a couple days and make a party out of it.
Yeah, so you went from giving a day away to trying to sell a few more. Hey, I like your stuff.
I'm just trying to make everybody happy.
That is a great, great giveaway. Thank you to Fly Fishing Bulver Outfitters and the bearded man. Yeah,
thanks
man
to
over there.
Troy Langelar for donating.
He's doing it. Thumbs up.
And Aaron's going with Troy. Aaron did go with Troy once, way back in the beginning.
Way back.
But we've only got five left. And the winner of this one here is Mike Ritzko. Wow, Mr. Ritzko. He's got himself a full day guided trip on the Bow River and a hotel stay at Hotel Blackfoot.
How about that?
Mr. Ritzko? Congratulations.
Congratulations, Mike.
You've just won yourself one heck of a night, a day. And if you don't have anyone to stay with, I'll stay in the hotel with you. We can just like chill and hang out. We can get the jacuzzi suite. All right, congratulations. Screenshot. All right, Mr. Ritzko, you're the winner. Congratulations. See, John would have flown out. Eric would have flown out.
Everybody.
Well, let's fly out, folks. That's how we're going to hang out.
You can still fly out.
All right.
All right. Boom. Number 29 is up next.
Wow. Number 29. And it looks a little something like this. Number 29 is a TNL Season 7 kit. A Lamson Glacier 4-weight reel from Rocky Mountain Fly Shop. A tacky fly box loaded with streamers. And a tacky fly box with nymphs. And two fully loaded fly boxes with streamers and Fly Fusion subscription.
That is a full pack right there.
That is a full pack. And the winner, he loves it. See? How awesome would that be?
Yeah, Mike. Awesome.
Don't tell his wifer that we're staying together.
I don't think that's what he was saying he loved. I think he's just excited to win.
I think he'd love to stay in the night with me.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Maybe clarify
confused,
that, Mike.
Confused, but furthermore, number 29 is the winner is, and there's only a few left, folks, so as random as it is, the winner is number...
Oh my gosh. Remember this
happened last year again, too?
Well, he's set up for season 6 and season 7.
Remember the same thing happened last year? And 2 years in a row... Well,
I guess that's what you get when you buy a lot of tickets.
That's what you get when you're good, when you support the fam, the TNL fam. So, as we're cuddling in the the shop, in the hotel, we can talk about these nymphs that you got in your fly box.
Oh, man, so many.
Screenshot, Mr. Ritzko, congratulations again. Again.
Crazy.
Yes. We know, folks, that it's not rigged. It's happened in the past. And Bruce Cole was the proud winner of two big things right at the end of last year's giveaways. So, as random as it is, maybe it's not. We don't know. But we have 30, 31, and 32. And number 30 is a pretty epic. It's probably the biggest one here.
It's the biggest, yeah.
It's the biggest, and we kind of keep that till almost last because after number 30... Well, you'll see what happens because we always got something to throw in there. But this one here
is two nights lodging at Wolf Creek Anglers and one fully guided trip on the Missouri. So essentially that's worth about $1,500 Canadian.
Yeah. Thank you to our friends at Wolf Creek Angler for donating this awesome giveaway. Two nights lodging and a full day guided trip.
So I'm going down there next week, and I'm really hoping now is my turn to win.
That would be nice. Oh, it's a big one. It's a big one.
Maybe we should cut to commercial.
You're so cruel.
Go take a pee.
Never.
Hey there! Oh, hey, who's on the couch, folks? We're going to come back to that. Furthermore, we got Mr. Fisher. Talk on the microphone. Let everybody know who you are, where you're from, and what's good in the hood.
Justin Fisher from Alberta.
Who's the other guy?
Here's Troy.
Troy from Red Deer.
You're not from Timnus Vale?
I'm not.
No.
I'm from Red Deer.
Tread Deer.
What's good? What do you guys want to say to the folks? Because this is a pretty big giveaway coming up next.
Aside from the giveaway, I'm just wondering if anybody knows a good hairdresser. I mean, this is...
You could ask Tiff.
I've been struggling a lot.
She has some recommendations.
Okay.
She could recommend somebody.
Maybe. Maybe Dave could do it.
Dave could do it. He'd cut off your curtains on your lip, though. Justin Fisher, what's up? How long have you been following TNL?
5 years now. Oh, 5 years now.
There you go.
Some good times.
What's your favorite part about TNL? Just
hanging out and chilling with you guys.
I was hoping for the bathtub story.
Those days are in the past now.
he might have had a bit of an epiphany while sitting in a bathtub watching Thursday Night Live.
A few bottles of rum. And
a little inebriated.
Trying to be a pirate.
And then he signed up for guide school.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. That's good. It's good to see you. Drove all the way up from Lethbridge, which is about, 3.5 hours?
Yep.
Yeah. Just shows up. Good friends show up, folks, and that is one of them.
Always glad to see
you. To the left, and that is one of them to the right. Troy's just like...
Hair is just...
Everyone who sits on that side is straight up wearing that hair. Norma Dickow wore that hair also.
Oh, man.
All right, so we're going to head back to Wolf Creek Anglers.
That's why I might need a new one.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, well,
right?
I've seen you earlier, and your hairdresser takes all your hair off. Prize number 33 is Tim gets a manicure. So, yeah.
Surprisingly, people have threatened to get me one, but never happened yet.
All right, folks, we got to head back to what's important to you guys, and that's just winning. So.
All right, let's go, Mike.
I just feel like I'm just going to do this. Wait, I got one more question over here for the couch people.
I don't know. They're on camera.
Are we still on camera?
They're on camera.
Yeah, you're on camera.
Hey, why don't you guys tell us a joke?
That's on you.
No, that's you, buddy.
I don't know how to joke.
This hair is a joke right now.
That's all they got.
That's all we got for jokes, dude. I'm not funny.
That's not true. You're very
Come on, tell us a joke. You guys have something quite simply that we all want. It's so funny when you put people on the spot like that. Yeah, it's just like, right?
Okay, you start with a joke.
Okay, tell me a
joke.
You're
looking one up.
That's a problem.
I know I am looking one up. Well, like Doug said, bad joke. Doug said, what was his joke at IF4?
Oh, yeah.
Where did I get this?
Oh, it was something about the octopus and the... Remember?
Did you
I gave that to you.
Thank you. So,
so kind of me.
So kind of him. All right. Where is that... All right, folks. All right. Well, goodness is as goodness does. I got busted looking up a joke.
And you didn't
so
even
I
find
forfeit,
one.
Well, I forfeited it because I didn't want to be called out.
Ah.
Okay. For the 2 nights lodging at Wolf Creek Anglers and the 1 full-day guided trip on the Missouri, which you're probably going to want to turn into 2 or 3. But hey, who's counting?
Let's see it.
All right, for the winner of number 30 is quite simply Tyler Hirsch.
No way. Oh, he's going to be so pumped.
Oh, dude.
That's awesome.
Do you know what his odds of winning were?
I'm guessing not as high as others.
0.001%.
Look at that. And he wins the grand prize.
Look. 0.001. Yeah.
Oh, man. I'm texting him right now.
And to be honest, I think he bought 1 ticket at IF4.
Yeah.
That's how it happens here.
That's how it works. The odds wow. are forever in
screenshot,
your favor.
I don't think I screenshotted a bunch of other ones.
Oh. Okay, don't take it off yet. I gotta take a picture of this one.
Oh, man. He's gonna be absolutely jazzed. Peanut butter jam. Tyler, we appreciate it. Unbelievable. Go buy a lottery ticket.
Just like that.
That is so crazy, man. Oh.
Just like that. Had you met him before I4?
We've been Facebook friends for a long time.
Yeah.
So
he works for Red Your Fire. I've known him. I've seen him in the hallway for years.
Yeah, like some hockey stuff. And
Yeah. You know.
But yeah, this is the first time I met him there.
So awesome.
Either which way, guys, hear me out. Okay, if you're from this area, go down to the Missouri. It's like 5 hours from Calgary. Like, what are you doing? And go visit Jason at Wolf Creek Anglers. It's just a little bit outside of Craig. It's just kind of a little bit quieter. Craig's awesome, too. And if you ever get down to, like, the Caddis Festival, it's pretty awesome. Craig, it's super cool. What we really don't have, and I'm not trying to throw Calgary under the bus, but we don't really have that fly fishing culture as a whole. And so Jason and Wolf Creek Anglers, we're super grateful that you believe in what we're doing and you wanted to donate something like this. So if you're ever in the Montana area, on the Missouri, give Wolf Creek Anglers a call.
Yeah.
So what's awesome. Up? What's TNL up? Sent me there. You know?
You know?
I think I screenshotted this.
Yeah, you did. For sure you did. Okay.
All right. So just because this is what we do, we've added a couple bonus prizes. So I want to know in the I turned off Facebook comments. I got to turn them back on. Shoot. How do I do this? Guys, first time here.
Struggling.
Daddy needs a 50th birthday fly fishing trip. Tiff will clean your hair up. Cheers, beers, and stogies on the Gasoline Alley Tour. Love the logs, T-Roy. Okay, hear me out. What was I even talking about? Okay, so I want to know in the comments. That's why I pulled them up. Have you ever shown up somewhere for a fishing trip and the guide says, should have been here yesterday? Well, quite simply, should have been here yesterday, prize.
These are one of a kind.
Yes, these are one of a kind. And quite simply, they are one adult craft, like, so it's an adult diaper, not adult craft, but an adult diaper from Craft Beer Nation and one preemie diaper from Craft Beer Nation. And so this is what we're going to call the should have been here yesterday, or you should have won the prize before this prize.
Instead,
Wolf Creek Anglers is not in Bozeman. They are just outside of Craig. So Bozeman would have the Madison. If you go just upstate a bit, the Wolf Creek Anglers is in Wolf Creek, which is just outside of Craig, Montana, which is about 40 minutes. It's kind of right between Helena and Great Falls.
Yeah. Right there, dead center.
Yep, exactly. Right there. Okay, so, well, I bet you nobody's excited to see who wins this.
I hope that Dave and Tiff win this one so much.
Oh, JB is going to need that preemie diaper. So what I was thinking is this is also an Instagram prize.
I think so, too. I would love to see
you. Because you could be sitting on the river, you and your significant other wearing these diapers and post a photo. Yeah, you might not have won the waiters and you might not have won the boots and you might not have won all the fishing trips and you might not have won all the swag. But none of those guys won the diapers. And I'm telling you, folks, that's going to be highly sought after here pretty soon because those things are a relic.
Hot ticket.
And if it means more to you, we can have them slightly used. All right.
Whether you like it or not.
But don't be depressed because this isn't it. This isn't the end. David Blackman.
David Blackman.
Oh, he's gonna freaking kill me.
Oh, that's the best. Oh,
oh, screenshot.
Screenshot.
Oh, David, he's gonna wear him on the boat. I know he is. Oh, that's so great. The should have been here yesterday prize. Boom.
Boom.
Okay. So because I have a bit of a cruel heart and all those good things, there's actually a pretty epic prize still to be won.
Yes, there is.
And that, my friends, is what we're going to call the Chaz Comes Late prize. So Chaz is a blacksmith, and Chaz forges up some pretty epic things. And so he's going to give you a custom forged knife. So you just got to kind of let him know what you want when you win this prize. And, well, he'll dig it done for you. So he says that knife's probably valued around $600. And so when you thought it was all over, and you should have been here yesterday, well, I'm going to tell you a little bit of secret.
What's that?
Season 7, I'm going to tell the secret.
Oh, okay.
I not today.
Hang on. Cliffhanger.
Cliffhanger. The lactic acid's going to build up real strong waiting for this one. Oh, well, I do that Insta photo on the trip. Guys, this is coming back to bite me because he's going to wear these things on the boat.
I hope.
So oh.
He's sitting in the front.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely in the front.
Throw some stickers. We could throw some stickers in with those diapers. That's for sure.
Definitely.
But this, unfortunately, is the end.
This is the last one.
TNL. Season 6, episode 13. We're going to go through our wins. We're not going to do the rounds with everyone in the house. They can write in the comments here. Because I still have a prize. And I have something to read for you guys. So, the winner of this, the Chaz Comes In Late prize, which Carolyn probably has never said, but either way, a custom forged knife from the man, the myth, the legend, the fly tying legend, Mr. Chaz Hillbilly White. The winner is...
Aaron Novlad! Oh man, this guy.
Nice!
He had a 0.24% chance of winning.
I would say he like rocked his averages tonight.
Oh.
It's crazy.
Wow. Screenshot.
Screenshot.
All right. That is the wrap up of 32 prizes.
And they just realized upstairs.
Did they?
Yeah. They're roaring.
Oh, man. Well.
Just like that.
Again, the app is called Pixter. Feel free to download it on your iPad, your iPhone, and give it a whirl for yourself. And it's as random as it is. It gives us the odds here. It tells us what his odds of winning are. And more so, Tyler Hirsch, that was spectacular.
Absolutely. I just texted him. He's like losing his mind. He's at work right now, and he didn't get to watch tonight.
Oh, man. He's going to watch it. So, all right. That's how that goes. All right. Well,
some great prizes, folks. Can't thank you enough for your support of the show. It's what keeps us going.
Wow. Yeah. I didn't get a pee break. Nah, I'm going to go for a pee break.
Got a pee?
They're laughing up there for something.
Thundering on the floor. All right, it's just me. Apparently, Dane's Dane, we're back to the polka music. But yes, we can't. We want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts that all of these donations you gave with the opportunity to win these prizes, it is what keeps the show going. That's what makes next season happen. So we can't thank you enough for that. Don't forget, guys, for all of you guys who did win, reach out to us, send us your email, your phone number, all these things so we can ship these out to us. Have a little bit of grace as far as the speed at which these prizes get out. It is a huge undertaking to do all the shipping and to get all those on their way. So they will be in the mail as quick as we can get them in the mail. And then for some of you who live in the States, obviously it's going to take you a little bit longer to receive them as well. But yes, so Dana's gone at the moment, but we're gonna be sliding into our wins. So let's talk a little bit about what that means. So what is important now? That simply could be anything. It could be anything in your week that's important to you. For us, it's normally something positive, but it doesn't have to be this super great thing that's happened in a week. It could also be a struggle, anything. It's what we talk about every week. It's kind of our favorite part of the show, to be totally honest with you. Drop in the comments what your win is, and we're gonna read through them after we go through ours. And it's really sad, I guess, that this is the last time we get to do this year. But
Well,
yeah. But your wins don't stop. So no.
Don't. Sharon, if you're not in the Facebook group, I highly encourage you.
Yeah, definitely join.
Get stuck with this. This is not a win.
That's because I couldn't do it either. 10% alcohol. I got to drive home. I passed it off.
So I'm watching Facebook. If you're on Facebook, we're not getting the comments, so make sure they show up. We can't share them from Facebook to the screen, but if I can, I'm keeping it open here so I can read them. And
I'll do this. Yeah.
Tim, you're up, because I've written mine down. Because I got a bit of a story that I want to share.
Getting late for the little one. See you, Ren. Love you, buddy. We'll see you in a bit. Huh. Gonna start their trek home.
Yeah. Okay, so, well, we're not gonna change it up. It's gonna go Tim, Mr. Fisher, Mr. Langelar, Mr. Dana.
Mr. Dana. All right, well, I'll start us off. This one's an easy one for me this week, because it's definitely going to be the show, guys. This has been an incredible year. This week has been like super bittersweet. It's been busy thinking about all the things we had to tackle today and this week to prepare for tonight's show. But just super grateful. This has been 6 years of building some unbelievable friendships with all of you and just building so many, you know, relationships that have gone beyond even just TNL, getting to see you guys on our boats in the summer. You might not know what that means to us, but it means a lot that we get to connect with you on a deeper level than just talking even every week during TNL. So thank you from the bottom of my heart for being here, for supporting us in the show like this. It's unbelievable to have the support that we have, and I think it speaks a lot to the community and to the family that's been founded around this group, and that's thanks to you guys, because you guys have made it all possible. So thank you. Can't wait for season 7. As much as this, you know, flew by, season 7 is going to be right around the corner too. So we can't wait to see you. And what is it? How many? Somebody said it already. How many?
I don't know. How many days? I think it was Gary said like 53 weeks.
Yeah, a few weeks anyways. But can't wait to see you back for season 7.
It goes quick.
It does. It really does.
Yeah.
A lot quicker than I think it does. So.
It's weird how this, doing this, being a part of this, has, I don't know, I saw something that said, kind of like hacked on like the purpose of life is to speed up time. And I'm just like, wow, we're like, can't wait to get through winter to get to summer. And then summer goes so fast because you're having fun. And then winter and you're doing everything to rush it away.
Yeah. But sometimes you just got to slow it down.
Yeah. You're just doing up your nails?
I just actually quite deeply cut my finger, so.
Ted's out of here.
See you, Ted.
See you tomorrow.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah. That's a win right there, that guy.
Yeah.
Okay, Justin.
Justin, you're up.
I had a couple wins this week. Well, mostly today, but life gets busy and a lot of things get in the way of doing what makes you happy. And, today I kind of realized again what I've been missing out on, and it's been a year and a half since I've been up here, and it's good to see the guys that you kind of build bonds and friendships with, and you got to remember to take a break and do those kind of things because life gets pretty heavy sometimes. And my other one was my grandma, a very important person to me. I had a knee replacement done today and it went successfully. So
nice.
That'll be pretty awesome to see her be able to get around. And, looking forward to that. Definitely be able to go for walks again and stuff. So that'll be fun.
Awesome.
Nice.
Grandma will be trucking again. Wicked.
True. My turn.
Yeah, Troy. Yeah.
You know what? My win this week is quite similar. Just like Justin said, things get busy. You know, part of the time I'm working out of town, and you realize, you know, when you get to hang with awesome people, that you miss hanging out with awesome people. You know, you're talking about speeding up time, and I know it seems like sometimes in the summer we take our time for granted because we see each other every day, and in the wintertime, sure miss seeing each other every day. I'm just grateful to be able to make it up here tonight.
Yeah, happy to have you, buddy. So yeah. Good to see you.
Yeah, I love you guys.
Yeah, I love you too.
It's fun. We, the three of us, me, Tim, and Troy, we spend almost too much time together in the summer.
Never gets old though.
But yeah, I remember the first year Tim was guiding. And he said, it was early September, and it's like, oh, I'm tired. I just can't wait for the season to be over. And I said, dude, hear me out, okay? The season's going to end, and you're just going to be like, where's the season? Where's the fishing? Like, you just don't waste it away, because just embrace the suck. Embrace the long days, embrace the frustrating days, embrace the tough fishing, embrace the good people. And it's like that, the idea of time is just to like, we, like I was talking earlier, it's like everybody's like, can't wait till I'm 18, can't wait till I'm 20, can't wait till I'm, when I'm 40, I can't wait. And all we do is just try to like change the pace at to which life lives. And getting to hang out here on Thursdays and be with the TNL fam just kind of like brings things back, and looking up in here and just seeing like people, all the people who donated to the show. I'll tell you exactly how many. 188 people.
Wow.
Okay, so 188 people, whether they wanted to just win or whether they just wanted to just say, like we said one time, it's kind of just like that tip, like, hey guys, some of you guys just went overboard, and some of the people that went overboard didn't win a thing tonight.
Yeah.
And that's, is it sad? I don't know, because I honestly think those people don't really care, and they're just doing it because it's like, hey, I can help out, and I can just throw a little donation in and move forward. So I'm not bringing up a win because I've got,
you got a message.
Little more here. Well, it's not a message. It's a message. It's just something I wrote. So what I want to do though is give you any last chance to say anything else, because once I'm done this, I'm going to hit the outro.
I'm ready to hear it.
All right. You got nothing else to say?
Well, I have lots to say, but...
Actually, I can't do that, because we've got to do their
yeah,
ones.
Yeah, that's true.
Douchebag.
You almost... I was like, wait a minute. Outro, what?
It's going to be you guys first. Yeah. We'll just me and Tim read these. Travis?
All right, Travis. My win, finding you guys this last year after 6 of my family members were murdered. You guys helped me through it. A really tough time. Love all of the TNL family. See you for season 7. Man, yeah. I mean, we're grateful to have you and thankful that this family helped you through It's a pretty major loss in your life.
Super crazy, because I say it a lot when we start the show, but it's like you didn't accidentally come here.
Yeah.
So remember that. And to which I'll talk about here, it's like this season, a reason or a lifetime. And some people come in, they get what they need, and they leave. And that's fine, because it is what it is. And that's not to say like it is what it is, but it's just to say, it's like if we're a gas station and you come up and you fill up and you carry on, perfect. That's okay. Some people stick around for a bit longer, but you didn't stumble upon the show by accident. And that's what I know for sure. Cole, his win was seeing everyone at IF4 and bringing the family to brunch the next day. I don't think we told you that.
No, I didn't know that.
You missed out. He came up with JB and Allison.
Oh, that's awesome.
Love everyone in the TNL fam. You're all the best, and I'm so thankful for the friendships that I made.
My win, this group. Yeah, this group. And everything that happens in it. Truly love all the people in it and everyone I get to meet, too. Picking up my very first drift boat, raft next Saturday. The adventures.
Ooh, buddy.
Yeah.
Nick's story we shared last week or the week before. So going to go into next week, positive approach to his wife's surgery. And his firefighter challenge has reached $1,500. I remember when he shared about it one time and he said, I'm going to try to make 500. And I was like, you're not going to try to make 500. Try. You're going to make 500 and you're going to do more. Yeah. And here he is at 1,500. That's super cool.
So awesome.
Yeah. We can share these.
Thanks, Tim and Dana, the sponsors, for another great year. Have a great summer, everyone. Thanks, Dean.
Thanks, Tim and Dana, for a great season. Happy Easter, everyone. Don't eat too much chocolate. Remember what the season is all about. Mm. Yes, that's a fact.
From Cole, thank you, Dana. Thank you, Tim. Great season, and see you all next year. Cannot wait to see everyone's fishing adventures.
Yeah, Tamara, my win, getting to spend all winter with the TNL fam, meeting new people, and having a great time at IF4 last weekend, and winning a prize tonight. Bring on season opener.
Joey, my win, season 6, episode 1, I mentioned my wife and I had a baby coming, and that was my win. Well, Here we are, episode 13, and our beautiful baby boy, nice. Fisher, is here, 2 weeks old.
Round awesome, of clicks. Joey. Yes.
Congrats, man.
Pretty much the same age as JB. That's really cool.
That's cool.
Craig, win this. Thank you all for contributing to this amazing community. And I love seeing everyone at IF4 and looking forward to spending time with the people from the fam. Mm. Oh, he's heading to Mexico for a week.
That's good, too. Aaron Novlin Sr., Jerome, epic season, fellas. You have fostered a great community of fly fishermen and are making a difference in the wacky world of ours. Thanks, Jerome.
Harry Tats, not Harry Tits. Tiffany is her name. Her win is being a part of this family. Looking forward to hearing all the stories of summer from you guys. See you next year.
Yeah. Mountain Grizz, do I know who this is? I don't recognize the name.
Well, because they all migrated from Facebook.
No. My win, I've had an extremely successful season with the online fly tying techniques online program I am running for Fly Fishers International's fly tying group. 3 sessions to go. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Just going to read some Facebook ones here. Charlie said, we got a few more actually. Barry said his win, great week, attended IF4 and Olds, visiting with my old and new friends. What an awesome day. Then another great episode of TNL. Ken McCutcheon said win for the week is tonight, of course. Seeing everyone come together to make the final episode amazing. Family, loving family. Can't wait to see you on the river. Drop me a line. Let's go fish. Mr. McKenna said hanging out with his win is hanging out with Dana and Tim and the TNL fam for the past 13 weeks. Already looking forward to season 7. Hoping everyone has a wonderful summer. OQP LPCF. Charlie says,
My win for the week was the fire you guys ignited in the boys last weekend at I-4 and seeing all the new flies they tied after school this week by themselves. And Luke is filling his new fly box from Rocky Mountain Fly Shop, ready to get out this weekend. Thanks for another great season, Dana, Tim, and most importantly, the TNL fam. Novlan wins. Well, ad libbing here. Tonight, all the wins. What a season, guys. New studio. Season 6 was epic. Dana and Tim, unreal energy. People culture that you nourish this year. Every year just gets better. Amazing group in the TNL fam. It was great to help co-host for a couple of episodes and peer into the future. LPCF, and there's an OQP here. Thanks for those boots with the fur and the salty flies and the chassis. I can't wait to cut my jammed anchor on some riprap with that new blade. Love you all. Thanks for a great season 6. And if we get a chance to ever fish together, I can't wait to spend a day on the river with y'all. Love people, catch fish, OQP. Terry's win for the week is coming up. He's headed. Oh, he's pre-empting wins. Are you on Facebook too?
Yeah.
Yeah. Go ahead, read some.
All right, Terry. So he said, serious thanks to you guys. Rocking it. Awesome wind up. Win for the week is coming up. Headed down to Houston to see Joel and Alicia next week for a couple weeks. Hoping to flip some feathers into the ocean and bend a rod. Thanks again. Great show. Great sponsors. Hope to be back in the groove next year with you guys.
Yeah. Jerry, when being at I-4 was a fun day, another win is taking a week off work and hanging out with the family. I think Norma said something about getting to help with the pancake breakfast. Okay. Yeah, she did. She pre-cooked all the
meat.
Yeah. Okay. Where are we at? Adrian. Go ahead.
My win. Happy to be with friends and have a good time here at TNL. Have a happy and healthy family I get to spend a lot of time with. OQP, LPCF, have a great summer. Nice.
Racer Roger 657 BD.
Roger.
My win, I wasn't online last week because my daughter's college basketball team played and she came home to watch it with me. And when your kid wants to spend time with you, you do it.
You take it.
100%.
Kate, win. Seeing everyone last weekend, friends and family. Loved it so much. Excited for the summer adventures ahead with everyone.
Yeah. Hillbilly, win this week. Mom turned 70 and her health is getting better. Thanks to you guys for all you do for us over the winter. Thursdays are definitely days to look forward to. Yeah.
Mike, had a tough week at work and my win was enjoying the show tonight.
And all the wins on the show.
And the wins.
Tom, been a rough week here in Baltimore. Yes. The bridge collapse. You saw that.
Crazy.
Nice to have a distraction and a refuge here on TNL. Thanks for all you do, and we will see you next season.
Yeah. Oh, Dave, my win this season, this new family, being here tonight, and big hugs from all the boys. It's going to feel like a long time until season 7. Can we tie ice fishing flies during the summer? OQP, LPCS.
Yes.
It's a great question, Dave.
Joel, my win was getting to sit down for the whole episode finally and getting to support the show for another season.
Yeah.
So a guy who goes above and beyond to more than take care of donations, and I don't think Joel won anything tonight.
I don't think so.
But it's just like, we talk about it behind the scene. There's a lot of stuff. Extremely grateful.
Yeah.
Just like if I got to shoot his wedding. It's just like there's OQP, and then it's like on steroids. There's like Joel and Alicia. Yeah. And it's pretty awesome.
Trevor, finding you guys just before the season 5 kits launched. This is such a great community of people.
Yeah, Chas. Win family, friends, and being a dad who matters.
Yeah. Well, it looks like open invite for any TNL that is or might be in the Houston, Texas area on the weekend and any time to get on the front of the skiff.
Maybe McKenna's down there.
Oh, maybe we need to go to Houston.
Oh, that's good. Trevor said, my wife Miranda wants me to remind everyone that it may be the end of the season, but don't stop looking for the little glimmers in life, the things that we call wins.
Yeah. Eric, my win. One last step to my guide business starting. I have some clients lined up. Fish are biting right now. Thanks for the TNL fam. LPCF.
Yeah. Sean Allison. Win. Enjoyed the season. Still have all but two flies to tie. Looking forward to it. Thanks for the great season, all. Yeah.
Colleen, what a fantastic season. Thanks for letting us be a part of it, Tim and Dana. Thanks, TNL fam, for your support of our business. We love you all. LPCF, OQP.
Letting us.
Yeah.
Kat, going to IF4. Thank you to Tim and Dana and the TNL fam. No mistake that we found you guys last year. It was meant to happen. Nick, sending positive thoughts to your wife.
Thanks, Kat.
Much, much, much related.
Oh, damn, boy. I know I say this often, but my win is just being here, making new lifelong friends in Tim and Dana. Love the TNL fam and the show. Wishing everyone a great summer with tight lines. I love you guys. PB&J.
just like OQP, like there's nothing greater like to sum up the people and the comments. And it's just like when you read them, you're just like,
yeah,
it's great. Like, so cool. Well, is it time?
I guess so.
All right. I wrote it down so I don't blabber and Tim gets frustrated.
Never once.
All right. How's the volume? All right, folks. Here's what I have to say to you, and then it's over. The season is over. We'll be back for season 7, and if we get booted at the end of this, I'm okay. But I think you're going to be okay too when you see what I have planned for you. But before that, I wrote something that I would love to share with all of you. To the sponsors, in the tapestry of memories that season 6 has woven, there's a golden thread that deserves its own spotlight. Them, our incredible sponsors. As we reflect on the laughter-filled nights, the masterful fly patterns, and the community spirit that has defined this season, we extend our deepest gratitude to the pillars that supported us every step of the way. A heartfelt thank you to Craft Beer Nation for not only quenching our thirst with exceptional craft beers, but for adding a flavor of camaraderie to our gatherings. Your contributions went beyond the brews. They infused our sessions with warmth and togetherness. To Morning View Mercantile, your graciousness and your ability to always pull through in clutch times will never go unnoticed. Your weekly prizes to keep the Flyingo bin full was a highlight for sure, and thank you for always deeply believing in our mission. Friesen Brothers for always keeping the bacon and the smoky cam loaded and our taste buds drooling. Rocky Mountain Fly Shop, Fish Pond, Shore Fishing, Fly Fusion, Lyle Peterman Real Estate, and every other person who goes unnamed, thank you for joining us on this journey. Your generation and your support have been the wind beneath our wings. The prizes, the giveaways, and the sheer excitement you brought to Flyingo, and to ultimately our lucky Flybox donation giveaway, have been pivotal in creating unforgettable moments for our community. Your belief in our mission to celebrate the art of fly tying. Can't even see. And the bonds of friendship within the fishing community has allowed us to soar to new heights. The success of season 6 is as much your achievement as it is ours. Together, we've created a season that will be remembered not just for the flies that were tied, but for the spirit of generosity and the partnership that you've exemplified. As we bid farewell to season 6 and we cast our lines towards the horizon of season 7, we carry with us these memories, the gratitude, and the anticipation of more incredible moments to share. To our sponsors, thank you for being an integral part of our story, for believing in the magic of fly tying, and for helping us create a space where everyone is welcome and every moment is a reason to celebrate. To the TNL fam, as the sun sets on another unforgettable season, of TNL, we find ourselves on a reflective journey through the highs and the lows and the downright hilarious moments that have defined this season. From the anticipation of season 6 to the bittersweet emotions of tonight's finale, let's reel in the memories that have brought us together week after week in a celebration of fly tying, friendship, and the shared passion that unites us all. We kicked off the season with high hopes and tight lines, introducing patterns like the wine booby and the pewterbog caddis, setting the stage for a season filled with innovation and creativity. As we tasted beers from our friends at Craft Beer Nation, we couldn't have imagined the journey that lie ahead. With each episode, we welcomed a cast of characters that brought their unique flair and their wisdom to the vice, from Novland's bullpen to the wisdom of Hillbilly Chaz. Tim's absence was almost obscure. However, the couch became a revolving door of fly fishing royalty, each leaving their mark on the season and ultimately on our hearts. The season was a treasure trove of firsts, from the inaugural presentation of the CDC foam ant and the copper john to the introduction of the Murdoch minnow and the hare's ear parachute. We explored the depths of fly tying creativity, pushing boundaries and challenging ourselves to reach new heights. Amidst the whirlwind of tying threads and feather plumes, there were moments of pure joy, side-splitting laughter, and yes, a few tears. Our beer tastings became a staple of camaraderie, each sip a reminder of the lighter side of life and the joy of shared experiences. The season was punctuated by the suspense of Flango, the savage ways of the wizard, and the seemingly incompetence of the captain, and the drama seemed to never end. All of this culminated in tonight's Lucky Flybox donation giveaway that showcased the generous spirits of you, the TNL fam. The anticipation of who would win, coupled with the thrill of the giveaways, brought us together in ways we couldn't have imagined. As we tied the final knots on the Never Sink Caddis and the Circus Peanut Hopper, the studio, the house filled with friends, laughter, and a few misty eyes, we shared our wins, we reflected on the season's journey. A tapestry of moments woven together created a masterpiece of memories. With the final episode behind us and the plans for season 7 soon, we stand on the brink of a new adventure, hearts full and vices ready. The bonds we've forged and the flies we've tied are chapters in a story that continues to unfold. Now, as we close the book on season 6, we do so with gratitude for the laughs, the lessons, and the love that this community has shared. Here's to the memories made and the ones yet to be written. Until next season, keep your lines tight, your spirits high, and your hearts open. Cheers to you, our TNL fam, for making every moment and every episode and every fly tied a story worth telling.
Well said, my friend.
And with that, I leave you with no other choice but to move in one direction.
You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you. Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your hair gets me over. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell. You don't know.
like nobody else. The way that you flip your hair gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell.